Welcome to the Classic WoW Hardcore Podcast, F's and Chat. Join us for the best, the worst, and most ridiculous moments in Classic Hardcore. This week on F's and Chat.
He's dead, he's dead! Stay away from the other Marine! Bail! Bail!
What the fuck? What the fuck? What the fuck?
Damn, this looks like it's gonna be tough, fam. Good luck. Yeah, it is, bro. It's gonna be a little...
Right.
I just died.
And now, get your F's ready. The show is about to begin.
Hello, 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 hello. Can you guys hear us? Are we live, chat?
Testing, testing, hello.
Are we live? Oh, snap, we're live.
Let's go.
Look, everybody, wait, hold on. Before we introduce our guest for the day, let me figure out how to do this real quick. Is it this one? Yeah, it's this one. We have a surprise guest for everybody. I wonder if anyone can guess who it is. It's Kigo. Anyway.
Pay no attention to the man on the bottom.
Yeah. So, Kigo, it's your first time on the show. How do you feel? By the way, Darken just dumpster fired 5 subs in the chat,
down.
Bro. He's just out here. Yo, if you have the F's emote, let's spam him, guys. Spam him for Darken. Darken's the best, by the way. Darken is absolutely
the
best, dude. Oh, Cargo's in chat. I smell Cargo. What? Oh. Winky's groomed.
Hardcore mug spotted.
Hello? He says Winky is groomed, bro. Yeah, Winky's groomed, guys. I trimmed the old stash.
Oh, you did. You did.
You know what's the craziest part, Kigo, is that I grow them myself, so it'll come back.
Oh, true, true.
Yeah.
For the next tournament, the next dueling tournament, you can twirl it up.
So. Yeah, I'll have a nice a high level. Well, no, you got to keep it low because in a few days it's Movember and then you go crazy
True.
On the mustache, right?
True.
So.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to be doing that. What did I want to talk about? I wanted to say something before we jumped in. I can't remember what it was, but that's okay because if I can't remember what it was, it's not important. So, I'm just going to get this out of the way now. We're going to start off, everybody. I died earlier this week and I wasn't live on Twitch. So
yeah, oh, you hate it, man.
That's a thing that happened.
Yeah.
So I'm going to open this here Coors Light and I'm going to actually turn my camera off and I'm going to let Ego roast me while we watch this together, because I have the clip from YouTube and no one's seen it yet, so this is the premiere of my level 46 paladin dying. And we're gonna, yeah, let's tab over and I'm just
level
gonna
46. This is the paladin that is part of the curse group.
This
Rocky
is it,
Mountain
guys.
Refreshment.
The Rocky Mountain Refreshment. So I'm gonna actually just literally turn my camera off wherever my camera is. I don't want you guys to look at me when this happens.
Oh no, the hands on the head though. Do they happen?
No, I don't know actually.
No?
I can't remember.
We'll
it's been
see.
A week. Yeah, I kind of repressed this memory, so I'm gonna go ahead and click play, Kigo, and then you can just react all you want. I believe this is muted anyway, so.
All right, chat, let's see. Oh no. Oh, the fatigue's down there. Oh no, you're still taking damage. Oh no. Oh no. What do you do? I don't know what you do in that scenario. That's when, look, what you got the one arm up. You got the one arm, but just unfazed. Oh, no.
So, Kigo, I was really hoping. Yeah, I know you watched the shit. I know you watched the F's in chat, right?
Yeah.
I know you watch it. Meaning.
They're saying replay. Replay?
Meaning, I know you know how to talk some math. I was hoping you were going to rip me a new one, bro.
Well,
because
I don't want to be too mean to you know, you'll never invite me back. So.
Oh, yeah. Well, yeah, that's true. Paid actors, dude.
Paid actors. There you go.
So. Yeah, I was over here grinding in the caves, you know, as as told by Kigo, you know, the best cave in the
as
game.
As everybody does, yeah.
Just chilling, getting my mithril, dude. I'm watching Kigo's stream. I believe I was actually watching you stream. I can't remember who it was because Greta was online.
Okay.
I start swimming, and what I'm unaware of, dude, is the fact that there's a quest over there, right? There's a quest over there.
Yeah.
And
yeah,
I was
the
oh,
little boat.
I'll just swim from where I am because I've made this swim a million times. A million times.
Sure.
Never once in my life have I hit fatigue. So the whole fatigue bar comes up, bro. The craziest part about this is look at how stupid I am. I legitimately, I think I'm getting a call.
You were close.
Oh, God.
You can
Hold
see.
On. Drinky, I cannot answer the phone right now. We're doing a podcast. I appreciate you trying to call, though. I bet you Drinky was ready to roast me, dude. That's probably what he wanted
to
do.
Well, listen. You can actually see the coastline.
Dude, look how stupid I am. Look, yeah, see, Drinky wants to roast. You know what? Maybe we should have a week where we have Drinky on the F's in chat, dude.
Do it, man. Do
That's
it.
That's funny as hell. So check this out. See this darker color right here on the minimap?
Right.
That is the safety zone. Bro, if I just kept swimming straight, look how close I was. So I started taking damage, right? I could have bubbled. Okay, right here I took damage. I could have bubbled, swam straight, and then lay on hands and been totally fine. But I turned my happy ass around like a quarter.
You were about to go the entire lake backwards.
Yeah, and then when I checked the map, look how stupid this is.
Oh, yeah, pull the map up.
Where's the map? I check it. Okay, there it was. I check it right after I bubble, and I'm like, where is this fatigue hitting me from? Because I've never had this happen to me before in my life.
Yeah.
Okay, this is the fatigue zone right here, this lighter area. Dude, I literally was so close to leaving the fatigue zone.
Oh. Okay, listen, if you wanted your paladin to not continue... There are way more glamorous ways to do it instead of drowning.
No,
how about
I
that?
Was so stoked, dude. And the
you're
best...
so sad about all of it. I'm just saying.
The worst part about it too is I was going across here to turn this in so that I could go back to Feathermoon and log out. It was that was the end, the last thing I wanted to do.
And you're done for the day, right?
Yeah. And I had just spent 3 hours grinding in that cave. What a great way to spend my time.
You know, okay, so looking at that map, if you still have it pulled up, the alternative, to get down, there's a boat that you have to click right there. The alternative to getting there is going through, level 49, mobs, water elementals and giants, or elite giants.
Yeah, if you come from down here, it gets crazy.
Yeah, it's very scary going that way. So swimming, you would think, would be the smart way, but that's all fatigue right there.
And if you play Alliance, which I do, I main Alliance, you know for a fact... If you jump off this dock right here and you swim to Feathermoon Stronghold, it's faster than actually taking the boat. It is faster to swim than take the boat. Everybody knows that. So everybody swims every time. So I thought, oh, look, there's land here. There's
that
land over
safe,
here.
Yeah.
Why is this one circle of fatigue zone?
Yeah. Oh.
Anyway, chat, you guys can roast me beyond belief. I don't even expect F's in chat.
I don't know what's worse. drowning or dying in the middle of fatigue when you're looking at the shore. I don't know what's worse,
bro.
Maybe drowning, I guess.
I think drowning is worse. That's just me though.
True.
Drinky, I'm gonna let you roast me in the chat for now, Because we have way too many death clips to get to.
We have a lot going on.
Stop bitching.
That's good.
Drinky. So those of you who don't know, I don't have donation things up because I never expect to get donations ever. Drinky donated and said, stop bitching, wear floaters, and stop drowning. Thanks, Drinky. I really appreciate you.
Oh, man.
Anyway, so yeah, you guys can go ahead and roast me all you want, chat. This is me showing you that, yes, I dish it out, but I also make just as stupid decisions. And we're going to see quite a few pretty funny decisions tonight.
Yeah, Drinky and I were joking around, like, because if I'm in a chat where he's donating, he'll donate using putting my name on it like I'm donating.
Yeah, I know. That was the trick. He can't do that here because you're on the stream.
Oh, yeah. It cracks me up.
Also, if you are anyone in chat is wondering, hey, I'm in chat right now and something seems amiss, something doesn't seem the same, it's because Grace for Days was very busy today and he could not make it. He was going to be the third and he just decided, you know what, maybe today wasn't for him. So next time we all see Grace, he didn't stream this morning either. The next time we see Grace, everyone give him mad shit
going on for sure.
Just give him mad shit for me. Just say, hey,
you know,
I really appreciate you on S and chat last night.
I like to give Grays a hard time because, you know, I played with him before hardcore. We raided and did dungeons and stuff, and he always tanked for us, and I would always be fighting for aggro because, you know, DPS warrior zug life. But
you know, he told me when you died on Greta, he told me he wasn't surprised at all because of the way you act in 5-man dungeons.
That's true. I'm very aggro. Like I love to just do a lot of damage, and it's what, you know, it'll get you sometimes. But
dude, you know what, guy chat, since Graze isn't here, do you want to see something?
Let's do it.
You guys want to see something funny that we did? So we can close that tab. I have to be really good about closing my tabs. Okay, chat, be really good about it. So. Yeah, OnlyFans? No,
OnlyFans.
So, during the tournament, chat, we watched Grays for Days. We watched Grays for Days from my stream, and I got to pretend to be Grays for Days. So I'll show you that real quick.
Yeah,
we were pretending to be Grays. I am Grays for Days. You might have to unmute stream, Kigo, if you want to hear it. Attention. I would like everyone to know that I am a furry. My name is Grays for Days. These are the Grays for Days faces right here. Get your Grays gasms ready. There it is. That's the Grays face.
All right, Mage Rogue, we know.
Wait, are you guys ready?
Filthy Axe is gonna take down the mage.
Son, not a single mage hit. Got
passed round one. All the rogues. It looks like
Grays for Days, dude. We actually got him so good after that too. Nobody clipped it. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna show you guys right
put
now.
Your camera up.
So we're Grays watching. So Grays loses his first duel. Right here. Right here. So in everybody in Grays, this is important. Kigo, this is also important.
Okay.
Grays lost his first duel after what, like, he walked around slowly, right, and disrespected his opponent, and he said he saw a dead man walking, and then he loses promptly, gets shit on round one by a rogue. Right Well, Tactics whispers him and says, before round two, he says, keep sticky glue up instead of bomb. And then I was watching Grays, so we called the insider trading. And this is us calling him out.
Ready, guys?
Oh.
My name's Grays for Days, and I need help. Tactics, please teach me how to play the game. I don't know how to play the game. Santa! Oh, jeez, I got clapped by a rogue round one. Hoo!
Good old Tactics coming in here hot. Anyway, I thought you guys would appreciate that. Now I think we should get into the actual clips.
Santa!
Santa!
I was there.
Oz was there talking that smack with me. So this is why he's not on the podcast today. It might be, I don't know.
You know, I hadn't seen any of that. So if you have any of those, like, you know, clips from them in the tournament, I haven't seen like hardly any of them. So that'd be pretty cool. I didn't even know you were doing that or watching him. You know,
oh yeah, dude, we were jumping through all the streams, like everyone was. If you went to anyone's stream during the duels, they were all jumping right between all the different streams. It was pretty sick. There's like a million
it's
angles.
It's kind of cool. Because you see, like, if you went to, like, you know, Jaman's, well, of course, you never had my angle, but you would, like, have his shaman right there in the middle. Mm-hmm. But if you went to Gray's, you could literally see Gray's fighting and dueling, which is kind of cool, too.
Oh, it was awesome. So this here, Kigo, we're going to jump into this clip.
Okay.
He's in chat right now. And this is Opsu, HC.
Okay.
Also known aka in chat as Disco Rev 1. This is Disco Rev. So he's a level 56 mage, and yes, when you're on YouTube, you have to go to like where it actually happens, so I need you to bear with me here. He spent like 5 or 6 attempts fighting this death class guy, but we're gonna watch the last attempt, bro. He's a madman, dude. Straight up madman. Okay, here we go. Level 56 mage, Opsu HC, also known as Disco Rev in chat, at 2:34:28. Decides that he wants to fight Death Clasp in Silithus.
A level 59 elite.
So
with
two
ads on it.
We're going to watch the fight here. This is a heartbreaker, dude. And of course,
I like the AoE.
Yeah, you know mage things. I'll let you take over this one.
That's the typical AoE if you're not a Blizzard mage. I don't want to like talk over and miss it.
The Flame Strike? Is that what you're talking
about?
Yeah,
you'll Nova, so he'll have Shatter, but you'll Nova, then you'll Flame Strike, and then Cone of Cold, and Arcane Spam, like, kite around Arcane Explosion, like he's doing.
So, fun fact about Deathclasp, but while we watch this epic battle, did you know if you kill Deathclasp and then run back to reset without killing the two adds, you cannot get the quest item off of him? He will immediately respawn next to his two adds.
Hmm.
So you have to, if you want to kill and run, you have to kill loot and then run before you reset combat.
And so he's got that poison that's ticking too. I don't like that.
That poison hits very, very, very hard. Very, very hard.
Oh, the knockback. Oh, he took 10% from that fall.
He's looking good though, honestly.
Yeah,
like,
Ooh. I think I was a little bit ahead of you while
you're
talking.
No, you're good. If you just pull it up on the screen share, you can see where we're at currently.
Oh, fair.
You'll just watch it on my screen.
Yeah, he...
Bro. So what ended up killing you here, Disco? Was it the...
Because
you went from like 0%... Or 30% to 0. Oh, they flurried him, dude.
Ooh, yeah, because you see, like, he gets knocked back.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like, right here, he's about to get, like, pushed back. He's at 32%. He lands, he's at 22%. But he still has Ice Barrier. He did, you know, did a nice little crit. Barrier's gone. Look at the damage. It just, like, a bunch. There's, like, six or seven.
And he types out in chat, "Well, it's been real, boys."
And I mean, he was playing it like great. He was doing great. You can tell he definitely knows how to play mage.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh.
That's a tough one to watch, dude.
We got to throw the F in chat.
Yeah, F's in chat, guys. When a 56 goes down, it hurts. 57,
like, you know,
57, I'm sorry, 57.
57, yeah. My mage is 49, and that hurt. I can't imagine being 57. Just something like, you know, and it, you know, obviously he didn't have to kill that. You know, look at it, it's a 59 plus,
mm-hmm.
you know, quest. You know, that's something. It's like, you know, you start kicking yourself in the back. You're like, well, I didn't have to run Alderman. You know, he didn't have to do the 59 quest. You didn't have to swim out to that.
I didn't have to swim out to that boat. I mean,
but he played it. You know, he was doing it the best he, you know, he had. Even, let's see, what is that next to the, what's a six? Something about to come up. Is that a
swiftness pot?
That's a potion.
The swiftness pot. Yeah.
I mean, he, you know, he's used a potion.
He had it, dude.
All of his cooldowns. He even ice blocked and he held that ice block for his cooldowns to come back up. Like, you know, like his blink, his cone of cold, frost nova, and
mage,
his ice barrier.
Mage is hard. Like, I did this on my warlock and it took 3 attempts because the first time I thought I could just kill death clasp and reset. It didn't work. So then the second time I realized I needed to like tank the damage and howl of terror and make them all run and then pump the death clasp down. But it was, and then I still looted and ran away from the other two adds. Like, I don't know how you would do this as any class other than a warlock or a hunter, like a pet class, you know?
Only thing I would try is, I don't, he's probably immune to sheep, but if you could sheep him and kill his two adds, maybe, but that's all I could think of, right?
Everybody? Kigo, it's our favorite time of the year.
Is it?
Do you know what that means? That means
we have
a clip.
Of course. Of course.
Not that one, this one. We have a clip. In the Undercity, what could this possibly mean, chat?
Maybe he's going to go trick-or-treating in the Undercity, you never know. Like, that's what we do here, right? We trick-or-treat.
Are we here for the 4th week in a row with an Undercity elevator clip?
Oh, no.
Is it the level 63 elite gravity boss?
A warrior, no.
Is it?
Oh, no.
This is Rocksteady 22.
Okay.
BT Dubs. Rocksteady. And we're just going to take a gander. Let's just take a look at what happens here.
Okay.
Let's take some bets in chat whether you think this fine angel sword gentleman, pretty high level warrior, he's dual wielding, he's got a very nice couple weapons,
he's got at least one sword from the either RFD or Scholar Monastery quest.
Okay, let's back this up already.
Okay,
was the elevator open when he saw it? He saw it open. He saw it open.
Yeah. Okay, so red flag right away. For anybody ever in doubt, should I wait for this? Yeah, always if you see an elevator open.
Are you seeing what I'm seeing?
Oh, death.
Bro.
Oh, no. How's that happen?
The god tier plays, dude. Look at him.
You know, I would have just logged out and just I wouldn't even moved.
Let me tell you how good our boy Rocksteady is. Let me tell you how good Rocksteady is. Look at him pop pixels, right?
How?
And he even knows Kigo. He's on this ledge right here, and it's scuffed. So when it comes back up, he runs out and then back in to not fall under the elevator.
Right, right.
What a monster.
His feet were sticking in it. Man.
What a monster. Chat, take notes.
God. Yo, can you go back to where he stopped again? Like,
of course.
Oh,
I can,
my God.
I can never stop watching this.
Oh, my gosh. The second the doors shut, he froze, like, hands off, like, you know.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
Look at dude. He's got 1 foot floating on midair.
Oh no! I don't think anybody could recreate that. Like
there's no way. I've seen one person do it. Grace for days, Drinky. You can't trick me into thinking that you're Grace for days. You spelled Grace for days wrong. You guys, hey, by the way, thanks for all the follows and the support. I really appreciate it. Driki, thanks for everything that you do. You're ridiculous. But mad props to Rocksteady. Can we all get a jabated in chat? Is there a jabate emote still on Twitch? Is that a thing?
Sure is. Yeah, there you go.
Because I, dude, I'm not going to lie. Rocksteady sent me this. And I clicked I saw it right here and I was like, dude, really? Did you really? And then I got baited so hard.
You just I got baited here too. The first thing I was like, oh, there he goes. And then you're like, no, he's standing there.
Hell yeah, dude. This is what we want to see, chat. More not dying to the Undercity elevator. But there's always a clip. There's always a clip from this area of the game every time we do the show.
If you're ever in Undercity or Thunderbluff, or Stormwind, or actually just stay out of the cities. They're not safe. They're not safe like you think.
They're not safe at all. Horde cities kill the players, and then Alliance cities have dragons that kill the players.
Yep. Or molten giants that shouldn't be there.
So here's the deal, guys. We're gonna move on. This is new TV, NUU TV. And this is his very first death in hardcore, and this is why it's important to watch.
You see where he is, right?
Yeah. I want you to watch Kigo. He's a hunter who doesn't have a pet because he's pre-level 10.
Okay. I've been there.
I want you to watch it and keep in like specifically watch how far out his camera zooms.
Okay.
And tell me this isn't someone who was brand new at hardcore at the time.
Okay.
Are you ready? I'm gonna click play.
I'm ready. Oh, wait. Well, we're getting the first person look through here. Okay. Oh, does he have the action cam going?
I don't think he does. I think because it's not off-centered, right? It's not.
Oh, it looks so weird. I get he is super close, right?
It's like so close. It's so close. He was first person for half of it.
Yeah. Oh no, he's panicking. Oh, what do you do? That mob hit so hard. Oh no. Perma days. Oh man.
So then he types to his Twitch channel and he says RIP.
Well, no.
I like it. Because we gotta initiate. So you gotta initiate your first death somehow.
It's initiation. So for anyone that doesn't know, this is in the Not Elf starting zone. It's basically the Not Elf's version of Skull Rock. And this cave is basically death if you're not careful.
Hey guys. He's live right now.
Oh, is he?
He's live right now.
What level is he?
I don't know. He's on a new character. Look at the upgraded stream, dude. He's looking good. He's on a hunter that's zoomed out further.
He's got a webcam.
We don't really get too many wild hedgehogs here where I live. I live in Canada. And
we just found out, chat. We found out he's Canadian.
Just like porcupines.
Oh.
Cool. I'm going to go ahead and put an F in his channel. Actually, I don't think I can. It won't let me. Yes,
Was
I can.
He like a follower only or something?
Nah.
But I know that
we're going to F him.
They just eat bugs.
Oh, is that it? Sorry. Hold on.
Chat, would you like to join me in F-ing him? That sounds horrible. I did not mean it like that.
And then, I don't know, with the hedgehog I have, I know you can...
Zach Efron's in hardcore?
Depending on if they like it. My hedgehog's really picky. So
do we hit him with
the... Oh, we're hitting him with the Fs.
He doesn't know.
So the reason we're watching him right now is because, FYI, he dies again, and we have another clip of him dying. What a strapping young lad! Yeah, look at what. Oh no, are we gonna F him? Oh no.
They're showing my death clip right now.
Oh, he knows. He knows. This is Streamception.
So everyone's coming here to pay their respects. Uh-oh. Thanks, guys.
Strapping young lad. All right, we'll come back and check on new TV in a little bit.
We can visit him later. Yeah,
we'll come give him a good old everyone, you know, thanks for going over there. If you drop a follow to him,
show him some love.
Kigo, me and you, this is the funniest thing ever, dude. This next clip.
Yeah. Okay. Oh no.
We were literally talking about this specific event.
I know.
Oh,
we
no,
didn't
she's
even
in
know.
Chat too.
She's we didn't. Oh, I'm we not gonna know. Spoil anything.
It hadn't even happened yet.
No.
It hadn't even happened yet.
It was literally in the same time frame. I don't know if you realize that. Like within like 10 to 15 minutes. And
it
we
was.
Had no idea.
And the Curse of Winky was in full effect here, Kyo. I'm not gonna lie, I had her stream up and I was in a different tab and I tabbed back over and she was dead.
Oh no.
I was so I was heartbroken. But let's watch. This is Sayadin. She's in chat. Say hi, Sayadin. Everybody say hi. And let's
Oh Sayamac.
Are you talking about for Halo?
Oh no.
I died.
Dude, she takes her death so well.
Distracted by chat.
I feel so bad for deaths like that.
She takes her deaths very well. Yeah, Cargo just said her positive energy is really good. It's crazy how.
Oh yeah, for sure.
Are you talking about for Halo? Oh, fuck this. I died.
The panic while you're in the air looking for something to click on to try and help. I mean, you have nothing.
Was it Tactics or Graze who fell off and lived? I can't remember who it was. Somebody fell off and they landed like... if you look at the screen when she falls...
That feels like a Graze thing.
It does. Okay, if you look right here, if you go like a little bit to the left here, like to where that little mountain is, there is a very small chance that you actually live. And they lived through it. I can't remember who it was.
Oh, no. I mean, you could see, like, in the air, her looking at, like, what potion she has, any kind of button. You know, if you're, you know, like, but you have nothing. Like, what do you do?
I don't know what you do.
Oh, the face.
Oh, yeah, bro. I got you guys. I have a Noggin Fogger macro. I can help you out with that. It will cancel anything that isn't feather falling. from Noggin Fogger. So you just
really?
You spam your Noggin Fogger button and it only leaves up the so you don't have to like click it and then right click your buff off and then click it and then right click your buff off till you get the light falling. I have a macro that you just spam.
We need that like stat.
I'll post it in the Hall of Legends Discord so everybody else doesn't get it.
Alongside Tommy's OnlyFans.
Alongside the macro. Okay, F's in chat for Sayadin. I won't roast her too hard because I did an equally, if not more, stupid death at a higher level the same week.
Oh, for sure. I will say my first hardcore character ever was a Torn Druid, and I was terrified that I knew the one time, you know, like I would fall off somehow. But I think what happened is like her auto run was, you know, was like going. I'm not sure, and yeah.
Dude, Cargo says gated content's an amazing idea. He only says that because he's in the Hall of Legends Discord. Right there with Tommy's OnlyFans.
Oh,
all right, Sayadin. GG's, Sayadin. You know, I hope Sayadin never leaves the community because we need people that are as positive as this person right here on her screen. And Sayadin, you need this face to be an emote.
Absolutely.
Shout outs to the level 63 elite gravity boss. Always taking someone out.
If only she could have waited about 40 more levels or like, you know, 30 more levels to get the Noggin Fogger macro.
Yeah, right. Come 40. But the thing is, bro, like 40 more levels, dude.
Yeah.
Imagine how much it hurt. How much more it hurts. Right. If you have a Noggin Fogger in inventory and you die to falling damage, dude.
Oh.
Oof. Oof.
Oh, I know.
So this one's a little small. I wonder if I can make it a little bigger for the. Yeah, I can't. It'll flip it off. So I titled this one Bruce Sheehan, who's also live right now. We titled this one Bruce Sheehan did not look behind him.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
This is like. So you're just casually playing a paladin, killing two bears at once, which is honestly sketchy, right? It's sketchy as it is.
You're
in
Dunmoro, there's bears everywhere, you know.
They hurt. They hit hard. They have a lot of health.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
He got half health currently. Potion's off cooldown. You're at 50% resources. Let's just take a look at what happens here.
Oh, no. But look at it. You wouldn't know.
But do you see the name?
Oh.
That's Ol City.
Oh, 20 plus. It's red to him.
And Ol City doesn't play games, chat. Look at him hovering the lay on hands button. Oh.
Mmm.
Rushin, dude, you just gotta commit, man. you just gotta run, dude. You run.
That's when you pop that bubble and you run.
I would have been running and bubbled, and then the first, I mean, you lay on hands while you're running, dude. Like, so Big Kitty says if Old City pats all the way down to the lake.
The lake.
I did not know that.
But gosh, he's getting chunked.
Old City is a killer, dude. He's a major killer.
But when you look at him, run up to him, you wouldn't think it was anything than just another bear that he's just easily killing, right?
Oh yeah.
Oh.
But that's a level 20 elite, man.
Yeah. That's why I personally can't use those fancy elite or like UIs, because you know it's harder for me. Like, mm-hmm. I don't know, to recognize that.
That's a good question. I was going to ask that, Kigo, because me and you use default, right? Yeah. How do you guys that use like LVUI and all these special UI things, how do you know when there's an elite? There's no like dragon that is around the portrait, you know, like I have no idea.
You know, I'll say this because it's in chat. Unit scan saves lives. And I say that every time.
I'll say this because you said that. Okay. This is the one thing that I always disagree with you on. I personally laugh at the fact that you think world buffs are cheating and unit scan isn't.
Okay, it's not. Well, most of the time, I'll say this in defense. Most of the time, if it pops off, I kill whatever it's announcing. So it's, you know, but yeah.
True. I'm just saying. Like, you got to pick one, right? You got to pick a side.
It's true.
Unit scan is so broken, dude. Like, I think unit scan is cheating 100% because that keeps it removes the head on a swivel, right? You don't ever have to worry about it. Terramis just walks up behind you, your screen flashes red, and right? Like,
someone's going to clip me. Everyone perks up when you hear that, for sure.
One day, someone's going to clip me making a stupid noise like, ba-doba-doba-doba-doba-doba, and they're going to make a song about it. One day, because I know that's what I would do in this situation. Anyway, F's in chat for Brucian, who may or may not also be coming up later again.
Oh.
Got to look behind you, dude. That, Old City.
That bear hits hard.
Old City. What do you think they named Old City about? Is it just because he's like ash, like from a chimney, and is he a black bear? Like,
I wonder if there's any actual story behind the mob itself. I'm sure there is, right? To give a mob a name like that.
I wonder. I don't know. Maybe there was like a famous dwarven chimney sweep that got murdered by a bear, and they like named it Old City. So the next person that's on our clip here is somebody who I had to pick a bone with originally because they had their clip on sub only mode.
Oh.
Good old Zeger.
Okay.
Zegers. Zeger?
Yeah, I've seen that name in chat.
Let me tell you. My man, first of all, he comes out here. You ever watch Crix, Kigo? Oh,
of course, yeah.
I think a lot of us watch Crix. You know, yeah, Crix like always dies and then he says, like, I can't smoke weed when I'm playing this game.
Right.
I think that's what's happening with Zegers.
Okay. You got the shades on. I see it.
He's got the shades on. He's got the sweatband. He's in a tank top. Totally chatted out of his mind. He's the most chad mage out of all the mages that I've ever seen in my life. By the way, AoE legend, as Easy just stated, he's the creator of the AQ, or the not the A, the ZG mob pull, the AoE ZG mob pulls. This man invented them, amongst other things. He is the world record holder for fastest 1-60 on Mage. FYI, my man's is a pumper, dude. He's a Chad Mage. Yeah.
Yo, he's popping off.
Chad Mage, very, very, very Chad much Mage. This is not his first time leveling 1-60. Right?
Definitely not a first time for him.
But you know what that means, dude? World records got no place in hardcore.
True.
Let's watch what happens here, because it's actually very interesting how this this goes down. First of all, he's like level 53 or 54. 54, I think.
In the plague lands, yeah.
He's almost done with the run.
Yeah, I mean, well, RP.
Yeah, he's so at the home stretch, PvP, right?
But... And honestly, for an AoE mage of his caliber, six levels, like 54 to 60, is literally a couple hours of grinding, right? You know, maybe
a
day.
Yeah.
This is the home stretch for him.
Yeah, he's almost done.
So yeah. Oh, by the way, he also is the only person I think to ever do a mage 1-60 in one sitting.
So that's where we are.
Oh,
or some weird thing like that.
Gosh, I can't imagine.
The dude's nuts. So you know what got him here, right? It's the fact that he accidentally put that spider in the AoE pack.
Oh,
because those mobs can fear. But the spider, the spider nets.
Oh no.
I also find something very interesting that I'm just now noticing.
What's that?
I think my man's, this is like his first hardcore character, I think. Maybe, no, it might be a second.
No.
I don't think he has a escape artist on his bars.
No.
Oh, he doesn't. Oh,
chat, do you guys see escape artist on his bars? Is he a noob hardcore player? Is that what's happening right now? Just thought he was too good for the gnome racial. Oh, he used it. Okay, Kitty says he used it for the first net. Where's it at? It's one of these 2 minutes, right? Yeah, he's gone. He fell out of his chair. He's done.
Oh,
okay, shift 5. Yeah, you guys are right.
Man. He's just gone. But look at how much time you put into that character, right?
Uh-huh.
Mm.
You put a lot of time into that. I think he ends up coming back after a long time.
That sucks.
That sucks. He just... You know what's funny, though, is on the way back, if you slow it down... See how that hand comes down from his head? He was hitting the pose off cam.
He did.
He was hitting the pose off cam.
That sucks.
Oh no.
Next time. He's already back at it, by the way. He's already back at
it.
Is
he really?
Yeah. Champion.
So he did this pull. Where was the spider at? Because he obviously didn't want it, right?
So the spider pats from the backside of this little house behind the two.
Okay.
Thingies, you'll see it.
Yeah, I mean, well, RP.
Man, right there. I can't imagine. I'm playing the mage right now, and I'm just not brave enough.
You have to toggle.
Oh, he got the spider.
And he was even saying that he was gonna avoid doing the ZG AoE and all that because he thought it was too risky. He didn't want to do it. He's like, it's not worth the EXP that you get. Oh yeah, core is for everybody.
So the hardcore community has a home base on Bloodsail Buccaneers.
Great guy to have in the community, though. He's a real, real nice guy. If you ever go talk to him, he'll cheer you right up.
I mean, that's awesome. Like, I'm glad he's already back in it. That's what, you know, you might have to take a day or something to, you know, get back going, but.
You'll find this one pretty fun as a warrior pumper. He was doing a ZG farm to like earn gold on his main character the other day, and I popped in his chat, and I love asking AoE mages, like, what's the best item you've ever found?
Sure.
Right. He has, I think he's found over 15 Cloud Keepers leg plates.
I didn't even have one of those guys.
And then he has add-ons that count how many times he's been in ZG killing things. He has over 900,000 kills on each crocodile.
Oh man,
my man is a living bot, but he's good at it.
Like that's just a human form of bot right there. Gosh.
Yeah. So F's for the hardcore man, Zegers. And we're gonna move on. This next one.
We got a lot to go through.
Oh yeah, we got a bunch of. We'll skim through a couple of these because they're quickies, you know.
Right.
Sometimes you just gotta bust a quickie out with your boy Kigo.
Okay. You know, okay.
You know. That was a joke, chat. Okay. God, I would hate to leak our DMs. Anyway.
God, I'll leave. Oh,
I'm waiting. Sus as fuck. I'm waiting on your brother to scream right now, dude.
I know.
So this one's titled Survivor because this is Survivor, aptly named Survivor in a Death Clips video.
All right, sus already.
Sus, yeah. And I titled this "Greed Kills the Duo" because when they posted their death clip, they said we overpulled. Because we were hoping that the rare spawn killed the person that was fighting it so that we could kill it.
Oh.
So Foe Reaper 4000's over there, right? And somebody's fighting it.
Oh.
So, somebody's fighting it. And they're just going to be like, nah, fuck that guy. I want that mob.
Oh, no.
So they're just standing there waiting. And then Homeboy's duo's partner decides to just accidentally pull everything behind them. Which is like a looter and three pillagers.
Yeah, you got pillagers right here, which they don't play.
Look, there's two on the right hand side of the screen too.
Oh, I want to hear what's going on.
There's no audio. Yeah, the comms must have been crazy.
Oh my god, look at it's like a war zone right there. Oh no.
It's
Oh no.
They're just pulling more, dude.
Oh no.
Death to pillager, man. Death to pillager.
Look at how many mobs.
Death to pillager. Yeah, it's bad, dude. It's bad. The 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Nine mobs. Oh,
and Survivor, that's after some of them ran away.
Survivor's in chat. I love it, Survivor. I love what you guys are going for. It's unfortunate, but also just help the dude kill it next time. I'm not going to lie. I felt horrible the other day. I was in Westfall grinding target dummy stuff because I needed more target dummies on my paladin. And I saw like that rare spawn Volchan, the vulture guy.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And I was like, oh, I've never seen that rare spawn. And I killed it. And I got a blue BOE dagger. Well, then I linked it in guild chat. I was like, oh, look what I just found. And then someone was like, dude, what the fuck? That was on Volchan. Why the fuck did you kill Volchan at level 46? Like, there's so many of us that could have killed Volchan. And I was like, shit, I didn't know. My bad, guys.
Yeah.
My bad. I didn't mean to.
It's like killing Broken Tooth, right? When hunters have been like spamming for days. Oh.
I have this feeling, Kigo, that Drinky just takes. He's just taking enjoyment in the fact that I don't have the thing up and the things that he is saying to me right now about me and you and DMs.
Oh, you're about to leak your guys' DMs too.
No. No. Survivor, F's in chat for Survivor. Yeah, honestly. Drinky's good people. My man's a cheesy troll. Gotta love it.
I mean, watching all of those pillagers, all it reminds me of is you being on follow to Cargos.
Oh, dude.
And here, Winky, dude, we got a lot of pillagers.
I never thought that Cargos would, like, let me down in my whole life, and then I put him on follow once.
Oh, you couldn't have had a better moment though.
That shit was ridiculous, dude.
Winky sent you a pic of his big toe.
Yeah, I know. Oz is outing me, dude. So yeah, this is,
you don't share that stuff, Oz. Sorry,
this is Isaac, and the reason I clipped this is to show everybody when you're a druid and you're in dark, like not Dark Shore, but yeah, Dark Shore. Right? It's the cave where you go in and get the mushrooms.
Yeah.
These like Naga people in the cave fucking clap, dude. They do a lot of damage. So he's been in this cave, you know, he's spelunking like full on. So he pulls this caster over here, right?
Right.
And the critical flaw is that he pulls the caster. This is Harkin, by the way. He pulls the caster with a Moonfire, and he look at how much mana he has. He has like no mana, like 3% mana. And these
can't even
mobs,
go into bear. Oh no,
he can't. Barely. He can't go into bear.
Oh no.
And these mobs clap, dude. They hit so hard.
Oh, the first aid was countered too.
Everything was countered. My man's. I don't think he can.
Oh.
I don't think there's anything he can do. Okay, there's the bear.
Oh,
it's tough, dude. It's a tough life to live. I just want you to know, Harkin, I've died in this cave before. A lot of us have died in this cave before.
Yeah.
My man's did less than 15% damage to that storm scale sky siren before he died.
Oh. Man. I mean, it's one of those things, you know, like, would obviously more mana would have helped, but look at how much damage that siren's doing.
This was more, I put this in as more of a PSA, like, this cave sucks. If you can go in there and get the mushrooms, just go in there and stay in the top area and get your mushrooms and get out. Like, don't go deep into this cave. This cave will kill you. And they respawn
a
bunch.
You can get everything on, like, the top ring, I think. But still, are you knocked off at the top? Oh,
okay, that's
no.
A level that we didn't know.
Oh.
Harkin, I'm sorry, bro. You got RNG'd into death then if you got knocked off the top.
Oh, no.
That sucks. Yeah, I mean, you did what you could.
Right. I mean, that's the problem when you're in a cave like that, is when you start to panic, if you try to run, respawns might get you, and you might do even more damage, and I don't know what you do.
Yeah, GG's Harkin. Go again, I believe. F's in chat for Harkin, the man, the myth, the legend. I love it when people are in chat that we're watching the clips of.
Right.
It's like the coolest thing ever, because then you get their side of it. Here's a pretty funny clip. I love his clips. Our boy, chat, everybody's favorite guy. It's Ferguson 25, back at it again, with a different hoodie. And this is kind of a headphones warning, so I'm gonna turn it way down on my end so you guys don't have to, but I'm just telling Kigo this is a headphones warning. This time Ferguson has said, you know what? I'm done killing other mages on my hunter. I'm gonna roll a rogue. The pose is so real, dude. The double hands on the face.
Yeah.
I think Ferguson is a staple in our community.
And you see, like, you know, the hardcore add-on spams it, and then you see immediately all the F's go in chat.
Uh-huh.
Oh.
I feel bad for him, though. I mean, he's clearly very upset right now.
Right, right. Level 13.
Both your potions are
coming online.
Both your potions are off cooldown. You hate to see it.
What happens at parry? Oh, no. And he trades.
Did he trade?
He gets a trade.
Is it batch death? Did he trade that? Yeah, they traded.
They trade. Oh, no.
I'm afraid to play Horde with Ferguson in the same zone. Easy.
Oh,
that's good.
And that's just a level 15 mob? Man.
You know, rogues, like pre-level 20 rogues kind of suck.
Yeah, well, I mean, level 10 you come online a little bit, but...
Is that a hot take? Am I allowed to say that? That rogues kind of suck pre-20?
I some classes like mage really suck till 20.
I'm not going to lie, Kigo. When my warlock made it to 60, I made my paladin and I died like 3 times in a row at like level 15 and under. And then I said, fuck it. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to go rogue because I'm a god tier rogue. I have a level 60 rogue. I'm a raid pumper, dude. and then I like died on a rogue.
Oh, at, like, yeah, level I remember 12. That rogue.
I think I died at like level 12 or 13 to I tried to 1v1. I tried to mono e mono the dude in Westfall. What's his name? Betty Blanco. I tried to fight Betty Blanco and I got put in the dirt, dude. And then I realized, you know, maybe rogue isn't for me yet. Maybe I got to do rogue later in life.
Yeah. I mean, rogue, yeah, they're squishy, man. They really it without evasion, you're kind of, you know, kind of scary.
Yeah, Benny Blanco literally put me in the ground. Like,
oh yeah,
it was bad, dude. It was bad. Oh, dude, you guys, the legend himself, Nom Nom Rob, followed the stream.
Nom Nom Rob.
Nom Nom Rob. You love to see it. All right, guys, this next one is Daislin. Daislin. How do I say your name? I think you're in chat.
It's always so weird trying to announce new names, pronounce new names. I think Daislin, right?
The Daislin? I think it's, yeah. It's good. I mean, Daislin has got the word die in it, which is kind of fitting.
And there you go.
Yeah, we'll go with that.
We could be corrected.
So, do you, I mean, I don't even need to click play, right? Kigo, you know exactly what we're about to see.
Yeah.
See, like, from the screen right now, you see Besleth is targeted.
Uh-huh.
Level 21 Warlock, or 20, is it? 21 Warlock.
Level 21, yeah.
So the thing about Warlock, Warlock's my favorite class in the whole wide game right now. Aside from Shaman, sure. I do love Shaman, but that's TBC. The thing with Warlocks is, yes, it is totally possible for you to solo just about every single elite in the game. No, it is not a good idea to do 90% of them.
Right.
Because the way you kill elites as a warlock is you fear them. And if you're fearing warlocks, or if you're fearing elites in a small canyon full of spiders who poison you, it's probably a bad idea. Also, right. Never open with Immolate when you want your Voidwalker to rip threat off you.
Yeah, let your pet go in and hit a couple times, right?
Well, so he wanted, I mean, we're going to watch this, but he wanted to pull it so he didn't pull the other spider.
Okay.
The thing about it is you have Agony, right? Agony takes a long time to ramp up to any kind of substantial damage. So pull it with Agony because there's no initial threat.
And then
it'll just pull to you and your pet will taunt off and there's your pet's higher on the threat table.
I guess while we're watching, because we're gonna watch this a little bit, the normal thing, you play a lot more warlock than me, but I have a warlock in the 30s, non-hardcore. Mm-hmm. Kind of the standard rotation is like open with Immolate, Agony, Corruption kind of thing, right? So it's probably,
you always open, like, with Agony saying, anyway.
Don't go through the motions with this spider.
Yeah, no, don't go through the motions. And the second thing here is, like, imagine pulling, right?
Ooh.
Imagine you pull on a hunter, because you've done your hunters. People in chat have also played a lot of hunters too. If you want your pet to take something off of you after you make a ranged pull, would you open with an aim shot?
No.
Right? Why would you open with Immolate? Don't open with Immolate. Never open with Immolate. I get that it's a cast time, right? And it's nice to get it out of the way while there's no aggro or anything on the table.
Sure. But
just open with Agony.
Oh,
and
man.
A couple tips. I'm going to give Daislin some warlock tips. At the point in which your pet is no longer tanking and it's coming at you and you fear it right here, don't go for another Immolate. Don't do what you did and heal your pet. You're above level 16. Sacrifice your Voidwalker while it's feared and summon a brand new one that has full health. So you'll have a huge 3,000 damage bubble shield, right? So when that thing comes back, you're not going to take any damage. And then you'll have a brand new Voidwalker that's massive, full health, ready to go. That would have won you the fight for sure. Like, I don't think I cast Heal Pet or Health Funnel. I don't think I casted that a single time. I just kill my Voidwalker and then summon a new one.
Right.
Because it's going to take you longer than the summoning time for your Void to even heal it, right? You might as well just sack it, get the big old shield, and then... And Warlock
you're
shields
using
are broken.
Your resources, right?
Yeah, 100%. I mean, you could even life tap down to like nothing and then bubble and you're fine. That shield is the Voidwalker shield scales, like it's 3 times stronger than the priest bubble at any given level ever.
Oh,
it's amazing. It's an amazing shield. The Sack Lord.
Oh,
health funnel does count as healing threat. Fun fact too, Kitty. Hellstone and drain life is like double the threat.
Double threat, right?
We got Drinky Donuts showing up on the screen now. That's not. Don't read those, chat. All right. So, Dyslin, you did a great job, though. You really did. I'd say you almost got lucky with that fear, because you know you didn't pull 45 other spiders, but. Maybe he killed his way to it, and he knew that was, you know, calculated play. You never know, dude.
You know, like, and Oz brings up a good point. Like, if it's me, and I'm looking at, like, I'm panicking trying to heal my pet, you know, that mob that's obviously trucking is only, like, 80% health, you know, 75% health.
Mm-hmm.
I'm thinking, like, escape, you know, get out. This ain't working. But, yeah, I don't know. You live, you learn. That's the one thing to try and take from all this is pick up some tricks here.
Yeah, Drinky is roasting.
They've suffered,
the Kigo.
So hopefully we don't have to.
Kigo, Drinky is roasting the shit out of me right now.
Is he?
Yeah. It's bad.
Get him, Drinky.
Follow this, Drinky. No, man. Okay, so this death is cool. This is Ariskello, which I don't think I've seen before. I don't think I've seen the name on Twitch before, which is cool with me. And I titled this one, How to Not Pull Skull Rock.
Okay.
So everybody, we're in Skull Rock. This is a common place on this podcast, as well as a very common place in hardcore deaths. But let's just check out, let's just see how this goes. I wish we had volume on half these clips this week. So you get the void, right? You get the caster, then you accidentally pull Gazrook, which is bad.
Right. So you got 4 mobs on you.
So the question is here, Kigo, correct me if I'm wrong. Isn't there a spot where he died right here that evade glitches mobs? Can't you evade glitch mobs here?
You know, I don't know. I'm not as comfortable on the horde side. I've seen it, I think. There's a jump spot.
A jump spot, yeah.
Somebody's used it before. I don't know who, though.
Yeah, there's a jump spot that just makes the mob stand there and stare at you.
Right. I think only the casters might try and hit you, but you could just line of sight them.
Only way if you can get that evade is hearth out. Oh, so yeah, there is an evade zone that you can get into and then hearth out.
I think where he's at right now, like at the top, next level up.
Yeah, it's up there. And it, you know, it's funny because I learned this on my very first hardcore character I ever made. I was up on that ledge and I jumped down to pull Gazrick because there was nothing there. And then he evade glitched and I couldn't hit him and he killed me.
Oh.
So that's how my very first hardcore character died. I was standing right where our homie Ariskello is, and I got murdered.
Hmm.
Interesting. But the best way to do this, chat, in the future, this is another one of those quick death clips that we put in as like a learning mechanism.
It's a hot take, right?
Yeah, the hot take. The hot take. Don't take shortcuts. Don't jump off this ledge. Go all the way around the cave. Go the slow way, clear it all the way around, kill the dude, and then clear your way slowly back out. Don't be a speed demon. We're not here to go fast. We're here to survive. Yeah,
the way is to kill everything.
Yeah, Oz knows. Oz knows the secret, dude. Yo, one of these clips, guys, by the way, one of these clips that we're about to show is fucking hilarious, but I don't remember which one it is. Ego, do you want to pull up, can you pull up the screen share and watch this one with me on my screen?
Yeah,
because I want you to commentate on this one, because this is a level 40 hunter. This is in the Sauce Gaming.
Okay.
On Kaz, is it Kazaral?
Stranglethorn Vale.
And we've all done this quest, right, where you have to go in there and kill that whole group of people, and there's casters and shit. Right. I want you to watch this because you're the master hunter, and you tell me things that I don't know, because I don't know shit about this clip. All I know is that he died, and I don't understand how he got in the situation.
So he's at that little campfire, right, where you want to, like, yeah, you want to kill everything there.
And you have to click the little note.
Yeah.
Yeah. And Booty Bay is right up here to the left. So right. let's check it out.
Oh, he aggroed the... Yeah, okay. Oh, no. I don't like it.
Because I'm confused. Shouldn't you be shooting the caster right now with your gun?
Yeah, see... Yeah, definitely the caster is priority regardless if you have these kind of mobs. Does he have Feign Death?
I don't know. I don't even know what Feign Death looks like. I don't play Hunter.
Yeah, he has Feign Death, but he's not used it. It's on the above his third bag, the little skull.
Okay. So he didn't Feign out. Now, right. I've played pet classes before. Shouldn't you let your pet, like, on the pull, shouldn't you let your pet get the first hit so that even if you pull that second one, your pet's taking the damage and not you?
Yeah, so here's the thing. He's Beast Mastery. Above, do you see his potion on the right, above the question mark? Two slots to the left, you have Intimidation, which I use, like, on pull. It does a stun, and it generates a big amount of threat. So you can usually open up because you know the second your pet gets there, it's just going to stun and get and grab threat and growl and then start its rotation. But
so is it an AoE thing? Like, would it have pulled that threat off the caster as well?
No. No, you definitely would have done that and then sent it to the caster. Actually, honestly, you could have kept it on that and just taken the hits from the caster. What I would have done. Just let it. Your pet would have got aggro on that. You stop hitting that raider and then send it to the caster, blow up the caster, and then, you know, deal with that with the others.
I think this next beer that I'm about to open right now is it's specifically for In the Sauce Gaming.
Okay. Because... Yeah, I mean, he died with everything up. That's one of those things you hate to see, you know? Like...
Well, and he was 40, dude. He was level 40. It's 40 and up is like the...
Oh yeah, it hurts
you on the inside, bro.
This is the equivalent to dying with like bubble, lay on hands, potion.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because he has bestial wrath, intimidation, Feign Death, which literally like hunters, if you do it right at level 30, as long as you're not like in, you know, falling off something or like in the middle of bad, you know, Feign Death is pretty broken. Yeah. 30 seconds. I mean, it's a complete, like, 100% threat drop. Nothing will look at you after you faint, unless it resists. But against those mobs, it probably won't. So even then, he's 40. Those might be, like, 41, 42 mobs.
It just hurts. That quest is notoriously difficult, too. Those casters really pump damage. And then
have
the named
to be
mob...
very careful with that little campfire area.
That's I think the name mob there is named Whiskey Slim, and he like nets you and all kinds of weird shit.
Yeah, it's rough for sure.
So the next one, we're gonna go on the list that I have here, Kigo. We're gonna go down to Nom Nom.
Okay.
Not Nom Nom but Nom Nom Rob.
Okay.
Because Nom Nom Rob, VIP of the channel, he followed today. Chat, this is a huge deal. The fact that we have Nom Nom Rob in here right now, I was in Cargo's chat, Kigo, earlier today.
Yeah.
And I saw Nom Nom Rob talking to Cargo's, and I was like, that's him, dude. That's Nom Nom Rob. And I went out, I put at Nom Nom Rob, and I typed out, I said, dude, it's the Legend of F's in Chat podcast. And his response was, I've been featured on the F's in Chat podcast?
He had no
idea. But what he didn't know is that... And then I was like, bro, you're on a... This is the fourth week in a row.
Dude,
he's on a streak. He's the... I need to make him a VIP in my channel. right? Like, honestly, because
he doesn't know, dude.
Now he knows, dude. He's been famous this whole time.
He followed you.
I know, and he's here now, and it makes me so happy because now we can share. Look at him. Oh, he's here.
Not this one.
He's
oh,
here.
No.
And you know what the best part is? Nom nom rap. I was showing Miss Winky, I was showing my girlfriend your death clip the other day, and she saw your picture on your channel, and she was like, whose picture is he using for his channel picture? Because she saw you with the beard and then you without the beard, and she didn't know it was the same person. And I was like, dude, I kind of like him with the beard. I like Nom Nom Rob with the beard. One day, if Nom Nom Rob ever streams without a beard, it's going to be weird. It's going to be weird. Anyway, we're going to watch this, Nom Nom. You are a legend in the community. I'm telling you right now. I mean, you haven't gotten the Immortal Legend title, but you're an actual legend on F's and Chat podcast, because this is epic. That doesn't mean we want you to die. We want you to continue not dying.
You'll get there.
Because this is what brought it up. He told Cargos in Cargos' own chat today. He said specifically, I am going to hit level 60 and join the Hall of Legends.
There
like,
you go.
And that's the dedication we need. People who are dedicated enough to be on F's and Chat podcast for a month straight are dedicated enough to get there eventually.
Yeah.
And when you do, it's going to be like the first time you put a coin, one coin into the Mario machine or some shit. And then you make it, you beat the entire game, and then you get the clout, and all the other dudes at the arcade are jealous. It's exactly what it's going to be like. Frankie, I'm scared to read what you're about to say. Okay, Drinky. All right, we're gonna watch Dom Dom. So he says this one's painful. This is another Hunter death, Kigo, so you're gonna know more than I do.
So far, so good, right? Well, he's got, what, two mobs hitting his pet? Well, his pet's about to die.
The head was on a swivel, too. He did look behind him. He looked behind him again.
Yeah, he's looking around. Oh. He's rooted.
He's rooted. And his pet's dead. I think this is the correct play, right? You run here. You don't try and fight this.
Yeah, you run.
Dead here.
I don't even... Oh, no.
This is actually sad. I don't know if there's a way out of it. I mean, he gets out, though.
Oh, but there's a... Please. 1%,
12 health, dude.
Oh no! And you could hear in your ear the firing up the laser, man.
And he, oh dude, you had it, Nom Nom. Look at him go. Defying the odds of three Quillbores shooting you with arrows after you potion, there's nothing left that you can do. This was so close. Man.
I mean, and you can't, like, please. You know, a troll hunter does, like, it's different because, like, anytime I see a root now, I've been playing a gnome for a good little, like, you know, I have a gnome rogue at 43 and, you know, Greta at 42. I'm just used to, you know, getting out of any kind of net with blink and with that, you know, the gnome racial, but
he says, look
what do
at
you
that.
Do as a troll?
He says, look at the I'm dead blink. Did you do the squint, the I'm dead squint? Oh no.
Please.
Oh no. Oh no. It's dude, so this clip is titled Disheartened. And I want you to know, Nom Nom Rob, you shouldn't be disheartened. You're a legend. You should be back. We go again until we hit 60.
Listen, I'll say this. If that lizard was like, you know, like a like what, 5 yards to the right, he gets out of there clean.
Yep. Everybody click on Nom Nom Rob's name and give him a follow. And go in there, and when he's live, attack him with support until he hits 60.
Yep.
That's what we're all gonna do. We're gonna get Nom Nom Rob to 60 through sheer pain and torture. And if I see you next week on the podcast, Nom Nom Rob, you might just win the...
Tell him he's not allowed to be on next week's podcast, so that, you know, encouragement not to...
Oh, he's fancy. Kigo, he's kicking ass on a paladin now. He's on a redemption arc. That's what you love to see.
I love that, yeah.
So this one, Drinky's gonna love this one. I'm not gonna lie, dude. When I first saw this clip, I thought it was Drinky in disguise. Because this is totally something Drinky would do. This is Juno Eclipse. If you're in chat right now, Juno...
I don't even...
I gotta hear from you, dude. I gotta hear from you. I want the story. Chat, we're gonna let this roll. Kigo, we're gonna let this roll. And we're just gonna turn it down.
Fuck off!
Turn it way down.
Stop!
The pose, bro.
The pose instantly. He's holding it too.
The
fuck off.
Oh no.
Yo, thank you for the follow. We're gonna watch this. This mic, dude. I want to talk to Juno. He sounds like he's OCE. Is he from on the OCE guild?
I have no idea.
He's got the People of Azeroth World of Warcraft podcast.
Right.
Fuck off.
I mean, setup looks sick, you know? Like,
It looks great. Oh shit, I'm losing everything. I mean, that's... You don't get better than punching the mic, dude. And what good settings he had. Also, if you have settings on your mic to where you can punch your microphone and it doesn't kill your ears.
Yeah.
Like, you're pretty good. You're doing all right.
Haymaker to the mic and it's just fine, you know.
We're going to laugh about this now, but it wasn't funny when it happened because he clearly was very upset.
It hurts. I mean, he did all that, you know, like what else could he do?
I know. I don't think he could have done anything. This was less about what he could have done and just his reaction to it was just too good.
Yeah.
It was just too strong. Yo, is this Square Time's birthday? Why is everybody telling Square Time happy birthday? Is it your birthday, Square Time?
Square Time? He said thanks, I guess it is.
Dude, that's awesome. Happy birthday, Square Time. My birthday is in 6 hours. My birthday's tomorrow. Me and Square Time are day apart, dude. That's cool. Everybody, happy birthday, Square Time.
There you go. How awesome. Interwebs is out? Oh, no.
Oh,
don't
worry.
That poor microphone, man.
That poor microphone. I want to talk to him. Because wasn't Cargo's just on the People of Azeroth podcast?
I don't know.
Is that a guy that runs that? We need the story here, chat. We need help.
Get us the details.
So this is Storm D. Stormed. Okay. Stormed. He titles this something funny, but we're just going to watch it. You know, we're just going to watch it. I love his living room. That sounds so weird to say. I love the layout and the colors and all that.
Yeah, the backgrounds. Oh. The hands go up.
Oh, yeah. I titled this one The Delayed Reaction. I would have smashed my CPU and keyboard. Wait for the reaction. He typed out that he died. And now it's hitting him slowly.
Yeah, it's slowly coming to him.
Don't worry, Square Time. I'm growing it back next month. And there it is. It hits him. Boom. He went through all the stages of grief in his head at once. Like it. Because he just, you know, some people forget to drink the elixir that lets you see those mobs, and some people just fall off the mountain.
Right. Oh no. He fell so perfectly in that, like.
He did.
Oh.
And then the delayed reaction. A whole 30 seconds later.
Yeah, you can just tell, like, he's just like, he's more focused on, you know, he tells the guild, you know, game over, and then it sits, they hit you, and you're just.
You love to see it.
That's a great clip.
That was a good clip. I liked Stormzy. So, dude, okay, chat, this is super important. This didn't happen this week, but this happened eventually a while ago. This is so important. You guys know how I feel stupid for doing what I did and swimming and dying to fatigue? So I posted in my chat, I said, or in the desk chat, I said, yo, I died to fatigue. And then Easy, who's here in chat right now, sent me this. So look, I don't have to feel stupid alone. Look, Easy's swimming and he gets hit by fatigue.
Taking damage.
And he bubbles. He's a paladin as well. Level 45. He bubbles. And look where he is, Kigo.
Oh, no.
Bro, he lay on hands. There's nothing left to do.
Who did it better?
Who did it better?
The combat log I love to see because you're just like, what is hitting me?
Dude.
And yeah.
So what are the chances, right? Right. So here's the thing. I was level 46. He was level 45. We were both paladins. We were both swimming to the same quest and we both died in the same exact way. Easy did it better. Yes. What pisses me off, chat? Here's what makes me mad. Easy. Easy's in the Hall of Legends, right, Kigo?
Oh, yeah.
Easy's in the Hall of Legends. This Easy died on October 3rd to this fatigue. Easy, you're supposed to go into the Hall of Legends and say, hey guys, FYI, look out for that fucking fatigue zone that's there so that your boy Winky doesn't swim through that shit and die 3 weeks later.
Oh, is this the hot take?
This is the hot take. I'm not blaming Easy. All I'm saying is had I watched this death clip, I would have known to not swim here.
You know, it's funny we bring two of these up because my hunter that leveled to 60, I did exactly what you did, but the second I saw the fatigue, like I noticed it, I'm like, you know, and I pulled up the map and I see that and I just turned around and I was more annoyed that I had to waste that time to go up and around.
Yeah.
But you know, cause you would think you could just like be at the bottom and just swim straight across, but
it's not Easy's fault, chat. Don't nobody blame Easy. This death right here is Easy's fault and my death was my fault. It's just how it goes. Neither Easy nor I was paying enough attention to see a fatigue bar fill up on our fucking screen for a minute.
Right.
You know, there's a fatigue bar that counts down from 59 before you take damage, right?
Oh yeah.
Like, dude,
it's definitely been on your screen for a little bit, but you're out in the middle of a deep water. You don't realize it, right?
Mm-hmm.
If you're taking that time, you're swimming. So you're just kind of looking at, you know, what's going on. So I don't know.
So
it's rough.
This next one is another one of my favorite people that we ever have on the show, and he's here every week. Every week. This is Stumble Boy. Jesus himself. Look at him. He's basically Jesus Christ, right?
Another hunter.
Oh yeah. And he's in Skull Rock as well. And Kigo, I can tell where he goes wrong in this clip. I want you to watch this, and you tell me where you think he fucked this up.
Oh.
By the way, he has the best banter on his stream. If you watch his stream, that dude is so funny.
I hit him with a follow.
He's great. Sometimes he'll give his lady friend a microphone and let her talk for him. It's hilarious. Like, he has a separate mic.
Of course he's aggro.
Oh, he's panicked. He's gonna panic.
Oh man.
The panic hasn't set in yet. The boar dies though.
The boar's dead.
Should be able to do it though. Maybe.
Oh, but he's getting chunked.
Or maybe not.
No. No, no, no. Why am I running?
Oh, no. Ooh. It's another one of those things, right? Like, well, pets, too, are so vulnerable at this level. But, I mean, that shows you how hard that mob hits, right?
Oh, yeah. So what I think he could have done differently here, this is just me speculating. I think if he stayed and pumped and didn't run, I think he would have killed the caster and been able to run from the void.
Right.
Oh, man.
So look how low the void is, or look how low Gazooz is before he starts to run. Two or three more shots, he would have pumped him. Any potions?
Used a potion.
One more, I mean, dude.
Oh, one more auto.
Yeah, one more auto and an arcane. That Shadow Bolt never would have come out, right?
Right.
And then you just run from the Voidwalker, maybe? I don't know.
And he's 12, but I don't see wing clip on his bar, so you never...
Maybe
know if
he didn't train? Maybe he didn't train.
Yeah.
Yo, Kigo.
Man, that Skull Rock's rough, man.
Skull Rock,
chat. Any cave.
Skull Rock.
Avoid caves.
I'm pretty sure this person's in chat tonight. And they're going to know it's them. If they're here, they're going to say something. This is the silver bullet drinker himself, dude. The Rocky Mountain Refreshment. Velsh, my man with the cores. Kigo, do you watch Velsh? If you don't, you should. He's hilarious. Got the best Lord of the Rings posters around.
There you go, Velsh.
He's got the best Lord of the Rings posters around. He's got replicas of all the swords.
Fair.
And he consistently drinks Coors Light. And he's wearing a hardcore helmet. Or hardcore hat, I should say. Not a helmet. It could be a helmet. Yo, we should sell hardcore helmets. Like, yeah, I've got my sweatshirt back there somewhere. I showed Kigo before we went live. I got a sweatshirt now. Anyway, Velsh, you're playing a warlock, dude. You know what's about to happen to you. We can call
you
it a helmet.
Helmet on. Yeah.
I'm going to cut him some slack depending on how many cores he is drinking up to this point.
Never mind.
That's
never
very mind. True.
Yep. We out.
Oh, no.
That was my bad.
Oh, no.
I'm going to give you negative props for the country music that you're listening to, Velsh. Natty's greater than Coors. Don't you start. Don't you start.
No.
He got the mob beating on him.
There's the drain life.
Yeah.
A little late on that one.
Oh my god.
The pose.
Damn it.
The hands go up.
The hands went up. Oh, there it is. The cores.
Gotta get that sip in. There you go.
I fucking deserve that.
Velsh,
I played that so wrong.
You did. You did. But it's okay. We all do. In his defense, it's tough, bro. He's fighting an elite level 30 at level.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
It's a tough thing to do. And when you pull the tiger, I think the best thing to do here would have been you feared
sack,
the right guy.
No,
you could always sack and run. I think the best thing to do here is, depending on your talent setup, you fear that you lock down the elemental that's elite, keep it feared, and then when it comes close to you, you sack, because your Voidwalker's not gonna get that tiger off you, dude. You just got to sack and kill. You have to kill. So you want to keep dots rolling on the tiger and then keep that guy feared and just say screw it to the void.
That's
if you're, you know, worst case scenario, sack your void, summon another one while the other thing's feared.
Man.
But
that Coors Light.
Shouts to Velsh. Velsh is best, bro. Velsh, what level are you on your current character? Because I know you're not quitting, bro. You bought a hat. You can't quit
now. He's committed. Got the helmet.
Hell yeah, dude. He's got the helmet.
He's got the helmet, dude. He ain't going nowhere.
I need a hardcore helmet. Oh no. Drinky said I should get a helmet. I'm gonna laugh and hit my head because Drinky likes country music of all things. Helmets out, chat. Hey, you know what? If you guys are a Jamin sub, you actually have a helmet emote that you can use. He's got the little
True.
The cave emote. All right, moving on, Velsh. We're not going to spend too long roasting anyone because we're cutting it close on time already, and we have a little bit more to go here. This is Maddie HC, and this is another Warlock Kigo.
Right.
Dude, I hadn't seen this clip prior to, like, yesterday. And I pulled this clip up.
Yeah, I saw this clip.
I pulled this clip up. Oh, Kigo. I legitimately, like, it loaded on my screen. And I said, why the fuck is Maddie trying to do this quest?
Yeah.
This quest fucks people in a group.
Yeah.
I think this is, like, the Warlock privilege, you know, like people think that they can just do whatever they want because they're a Warlock.
Yeah, I mean, and you're level 49.
Are you ready for the shade, though? Are you ready for the shade?
Let's go.
You should never do this quest, chat, even if you're a Warlock. But your boy Winky did it on my Warlock. Let me tell you, Kigo, it took me, when I did this quest, it took me 45 minutes to kill 3 enemies because I had to pull them out and kill one individually every time and then run and reset them. And in order to run and reset them, you have to clear this entire cave. It's fucking horrible. Mm. But you know who did do this quest like a champ was Tactics on his Warlock.
Warlock privilege.
And
okay,
that's the reason, this is the reason I did it, because I could not let Tactics get away with doing something that I didn't do shortly behind him. But let's watch Maddie. It hurts to watch.
Yeah, it's painful.
It's also cool to see a Warlock using a staff at the higher levels. I think most of the quest items on the Horde lean more towards one-handers and offhands. The Howl of Terror comes out. Good play.
Yeah, good play.
Never mind.
Oh, no. Panic. Oh, no.
That's the idea, though. That was the play. I mean, you're supposed to... Why didn't it come out?
Look how fast.
Yeah, you get clapped. These dudes mess you up. Okay, so
look how fast his Void dies.
Yeah, the Void got clapped.
Oh my lord. The Hellstone, I didn't even get the potion off.
It's so fast. These guys chunk you. So you know what? You know the way to do this. There is a way to do it. And there's the only way to do it is to pull each one of them at a time, right? You cannot tank these. These are not your Void and you cannot tank these. You have to kite like a monster. So what you do is you sticky glue Overseer Maltorius to pull, and you fear one, and you put your pet on the one that you're about to kill.
Oh.
And then you basically, when your Voidwalker, Warlocks that play hardcore need to realize the size of the shield you get when you sack your Void doesn't matter how much health your Void has. So you can honestly batch the sack and your Void dying at the same time to maximize your resources. So you let your Void take a few hits while you dot up that mob. The Void dies, you start running, right? You get distance before your Void's even dead. Right when your Void's about to die, like 1-2% health, sack that shit. And then literally you're so far away, they're ticking at you. They're running, taking dot ticks. The other two are off of fear and sticky glue. So then all you have to do is you fear the one that's dotted once it gets caught up to you, and you dot it up again, and then you just run and you hope that it dies and the other two reset. That's the only way.
Right.
It's like the only way you can do this. There's no other way. The Howl of Terror was a good idea.
Yeah, I mean, okay, can you theoretically sacrifice your Voidwalker, grab another one out, and go in?
100%. Always do that. Yeah, no, for sure. You can start all combat.
He would have got the Howl. Yeah. So if he gets, if he did that and got the Howl of Terror off, because he would have, does he, is he able to grab the book and jump off?
If you're just going for the book, absolutely. If you are trying to get the quest for killing him, no. Okay. But yeah, if you wanted to, that's another, you know, you could sack your void, get another void ready, send the void in to die, get the book, and then when your void's about to die, you bubble again and then jump off, and then you're good.
Okay, so let me tell you real quick while we're staring right where you're looking at. I almost did this quest on my hunter. I was looking at it, and everyone in chat was like, no. I think even Tactics said no. He said, don't do it. Because my plan was going to, like, throw my pet. I'm playing Mortal Pet, too, so it's a big factor if my pet dies to me. Yeah, Big Kitty might have been telling me to run. I'm looking. My plan was to send my pet in for aggro and then target a mob and just send it far away and then just walk past them. And that might have worked, but it was way, you know, if it doesn't.
Yeah, this quest is props to anyone who even attempts this. Like, Maddie, if you ever see this or if you're in chat, mad props to you. This is an F out of respect, because the fact that you tried that shit, like...
Yeah.
This quest sucks. This sucks bad. Let's see. You know what's next on the list here, Kigo, down? It's a bit of a controversial thing.
Okay. Oh, no.
But who doesn't love Jamazing?
Right.
Right.
Yeah, I haven't actually seen this part of it.
So this is sus amazing, dude. Super sus. Jez, one of my favorite people, too, especially when we play Among Us. Sure. That's awesome. So we're gonna watch this. Doesn't die here, chat. But we're gonna go over it. If you're not aware currently of the situation, we're gonna watch this poll. Is there audio on this, Jet? I don't know. I don't think there is. Oh no, yeah, there is.
Okay.
You know why I respect you, Jem? It takes a certain kind of individual to wear a zip-up hoodie without a shirt on underneath.
That's brave.
It takes a brave person to wear a zip-up hoodie without a shirt on underneath. And I couldn't do it. Partially because when I wear zip-up hoodies... I don't wash my sweatshirts. I maybe wash my sweatshirts like 20% of the amount of time I wash my other clothing, right? And I don't want sweat and stuff to get on there. It was Sunday morning.
It's early.
You know, Jay, you could have just been like, dude, I had a wife beater on under there, or like a tank top. So look how close Jay is to dying on a paladin. He bubbles. The bubble comes out.
Right.
Lay on Hands comes out. And these Curzons, man, they pump. They're pumping.
Right. It's spooky, very spooky place to be.
Yep. That rogue Curzon didn't reset very far. So Jeb pops the Light of Elune.
Right.
Is invulnerability for 10 seconds, right? And Hearthstones out. And then hits the pose anyway. He hits the pose anyway.
Right.
It's like foreshadowing. So, to those who don't know, chat, Kigo, would you like to explain what?
Well, I mean, so the Light of Elune, it was a rule that was made before my time coming up here, but basically, it's the Light of Elune is something only Alliance get, and it's an item from a quest. Like, basically gives you, it's a pally bubble. It gives you a 10-second pally bubble. And, you know, it's really strong. You know, he was able to bubble, lay on hands, and use that. So, like, I mean, it's, but you can only use it one time. But somewhere over about, it's like a month and like 5 or 10 days ago, it was decided to roll out the Hearth bubble, or the Light of Elune and Hearth Home kind of thing, because... you know, it's one of those things. You can't bubble hearth on a pally, but, you know, other people would just get in a situation like that and just hearth out. So you basically got a guaranteed save my life button and, you know, kind of went against the heart of everything, right? So,
in the spirit of hardcore, it is currently against the rules to light a balloon in Hearthstone. And Ja was unaware of that rule because it was created after the date he made this paladin.
He'd had this paladin going even before that.
So there is some controversy over whether or not he should have a grace period between the rule releasing and him having to abide by it, like we did in the past with the shared bank system. You know, we had a shared bank system at one point. If you had started a character before that system had ended, you were allowed to play that character out whether you made it or not, right?
Yeah, because I mean, it's a good thing to point out here that, you know, rules are changing, so try and keep up to date with those on Discord.
Public service announcement: make sure you check the rules every once in a while, and if you hear a little bit of buzz in the community about the rules, it's probably because something changed. I don't think we've had a change since that Light of a Loon, though.
No, 9:15. This is the last
so
change.
It's been over a month. No rules have changed. Nothing's crazy. But Jed made the decision to say, fuck it, I broke the rules. I'm deleting my character.
Right.
And the coolest part about this is that Ja is such a unique, awesome person, like, individually.
Right.
But the way he went about killing his character is just, like, the coolest thing ever.
Oh, no one's done it before. Like,
first of all, I'm going to pull the clip up. I have a clip that I got because I was there watching it when it went down. The coolest part about this is that Ja went out on a... Yo, Dark Wolf, thanks. Joe went out and bought a veil. It's not in this clip, but he bought a straight up veil for the funeral service. Had an actual funeral for the characters, said his piece. Then promptly ran his paladin ass straight into Orgrimmar to get clapped by the guards. So we're going to watch this
out of respect.
One's done this. No one has.
No one's done something like this yet.
This is a hardcore first. So we're going to watch this clip out of respect for Jamazing, the paladin in the 40s who died valiantly to the Orgrimmar guards. And I believe chat voted on this, on how he went out.
Oh, I did not get very far.
Look at, he's in a suit and tie, dude.
I've got bubble.
Yeah.
Suck on that.
He put the teardrop mascara on.
That's what he was
on.
Wearing under the zip up hoodie.
The makeup was bleeding because he was crying so much.
Hey, they left me alone. Right. That's nice. Well, they're like,
look how far he's
I'm
getting
going
in.
To lay on. Oh, oh, look at that sweet lay on hands. Oh, here's the moment. Oh,
what a legend.
Why didn't
they yeah, absolutely.
Oh,
like
our brave brother Jamazing the Paladin has died at level 42 in Orgrimmar.
I think too. Can you go back to where you used lay on hands?
Yeah, of course.
Oh, look at that sweet lay on hands.
Oh, his lay on hands was clutch. It was low.
Hey, they left.
I think it said 0% when he
lay
on hands.
I'm going to lay on. Oh,
yep,
yeah,
it was 0%.
Oh, sweet lay on hands.
Biss lay on hands. Real
that
gamer.
Was like perfect. Yeah, can we get an F in chat for
100%? Yeah, F in chat for Jamazing. Also, the most suspect player of Among Us.
If you guys haven't yet, go hit him with a follow here.
Yeah, everyone should follow Jamazing. Fun fact, Jamazing, since you're in chat right now, I'm going to point this out to you in case you ever wanted to troll the living shit out of us as viewers. So when you're running into this area of Orgrimmar as an Alliance character, there's a tower to the right-hand side of the screen once you get in. If you bubble on your paladin, you see how those first sets of guards reset? If you hug the right wall and run all the way to that ledge to the right-hand side behind the bonfire right now, you can tank a couple hits from this guard and then lay on hands, and all of these guards will reset, and then you can live indefinitely forever in Orgrimmar without ever having a guard attack you. Fun fact. You learn that raiding a bunch of Orgrimmar raids with Taxic. We used to do that because our server wasn't a PvP server, so we would go in there and bait people into attacking us, and then we'd have like 80 people come over a mountain and clap everybody.
Right.
It's fun times though. Don't plan on using it. So Cargo's actually sent me this clip. This next one. This one's pretty cool. So you know Cargo's is all up on his warrior hype right now, right? Like he's all about the warrior. He just loves the warrior today, these days. Yeah. So this is, why is my clip screen not working? There we go. This is Orym. Orym HC. Check Discord after. All right, Whiskey, let's see what you got. Hold on. Hot take. So my guild leader just sent me something. You want to listen to it, chat?
Yeah.
So Farty Pants in chat is my guild leader on my raiding guild.
The hot take.
Dude, he sent a hot take clip. Chat, we have a hot take clip for the Winky Hot Takes. Put the audio on the stream, Kigo. See if you can hear it. Hold on.
The hot take.
Dude, he put a Murloc death sound.
The hot take.
Yo, that is so good, Whiskey. That is so good.
Yo.
So you guys, awesome. Anyone that doesn't know, Farty Pants in chat is my guild leader in our raiding guild. Also, he's a movie trailer editor for a living, and sometimes he is the in a world, like that guy, the voiceover guy. So he did the voiceover work for the whole intro to the F's and chat stuff too.
That's awesome. Total
fucking badass. Anyway, well, all right, moving on. This is Cargo's clip because Cargo's is all about dope warriors doing dope things right now because he's on that warrior hype. So he said that this was a valiant effort by Orym, and he really wanted us to take a look at it. So here we are.
Okay.
This is a level 30 warrior. I believe that, is this in Desolus? I've never actually been in this cave.
Split hoof hold. Let's see, he's level 30, so it's right around that level, right?
I think this is, so if you do the centaur quest to kill the centaurs, correct me if I'm wrong, chat. I always do the centaur. I kill the centaurs on the left, and then on the right, I don't. But if you kill the other centaurs, I think you get a quest to go in this cave.
Hmm. Oh, no, it's... The potion.
I have no idea what's even going on. I'm such a noob when it comes to warrior. But there's the target dummy.
Target dummy. I think he's the target dummy went down.
So he goes to the spot where he could evade these mobs and then doesn't evade them because he's not out. He didn't jump up there, right?
Right.
It's that little rock to the left, that little floating rock right there. You can jump on that and it'll evade the mobs.
1v1.
Mono e mono. Did he switch to dual wield? Cannibalize comes out? Yeah, he switched to dual wield.
He dual wield.
I thought he was a two-hander originally.
He might do a overpower macro.
Did that auto attack break the grenade?
I think so.
Bro.
Oh, no.
Imagine being Torrencore right now, the guy that's whispering him.
Yeah. Yo, hey. Yo, talk to me about this stuff.
He says, hey, warrior question for you. What do you recommend, engineering or blacksmithing? And they're talking. They're chilling. And then all of a sudden you see in guild chat that your boy that you're literally talking to right now has died in a cave.
Yeah. He's level 30.
Retail was the correct play.
Retail.
So he could just not get the hit out on that last one before it pulled an extra.
So he has sweeping strikes on his bar.
Oh my god, Drinky. What are you doing to me? Drinky's killing me, Kigo. This better have something to do with this warrior, Drinky. Way better movie guy joke.
I mean, look how long this guy's in this like fight for his life too.
I know, it's a long fight. This warrior put in a lot of work. I think a lot of it could have been a
and he just whipped he just swapped a dual wield here, and I think he did it in a hopes, because, like, you know, Cargo's knows of anybody. I saw him today. Cargo's on stream. That's all. When you're this low, you don't want to see parry, you know, dodge, miss, right? And if you got a two-hander and you're, like, low, you don't want to risk getting parried and that then wait another 3.5 seconds for another swing.
So I think this could have been avoided in two different areas, Kigo. I think he could have avoided it by jumping to the evade spot.
Yeah.
But also a less, you know, pansy kind of way of actually avoiding it, right? A less, quote, clever use of game mechanics way would be use your iron grenade.
Yeah.
On the mob that runs and pulls that third mob before it pulls.
True.
Because you were, like, one hit away from killing it right here. Grenade it so yeah. It doesn't pull that. Right?
Because I mean, once you're looking at that angle you're looking at right now and you see it going in that direction.
Yeah, you grenade that son of a bitch. That's yeah. What you, yeah. 100%. Damn, he put in so much work. Weapon swapping, bro. Like.
And let's take pause it just a second. Even at this position, if you're on a warlock. You know, if you're on a mage, you know, Magus Novas walks over and polymorphs one, you know, kills the other, you know, the warlock fears one, you know, kills the other. All that, like, this is why warriors are so difficult and hardcore, because, you know, what can you do? Like, you could maybe fear it, right? You could fear.
Yeah. You know, I think mentality on a warrior is a big thing, right? Because you need to change your mindset of what options do I have to escape? You need to change that mindset to what options do I have to fucking kill this shit before it kills me?
Yeah.
Like, that's
all. You just
got
to hit it harder.
You just got to pump it down. You have to pump it down. There's nothing else. I mean, you can hamstring or whatever it is?
Yeah, if he had hamstring going, he does have fear right now. I don't know if he uses it. He does. Above his like eight or nine.
Oh, Sayadin just called out the sticky glue play.
True.
The question,
ooh, sticky
though,
glue as soon as it goes to run, right?
I can see 4 slumber sand on his bars. I don't see any sticky glue, because getting to level 30 on a warrior, I imagine you use all your sticky glue as is, right? Like,
but do you use slumber sand when it goes to run and just get?
You ever see Nom Nom play his warrior, Kigo? He's like straight up. It's every pull is a close call. Every single pull is a close call.
Yeah, warrior is no joke. Especially once you're getting into the 30s and 40s. Everything, you know, it's rough.
Dude, one day.
He's got a food buff.
One day I'm going to convince Nomad Roots. Because, you know, he's the warrior master. One day I'm going to convince Nomad Roots to play a warlock, and he's never going to go back to warrior.
He'll never go back.
He'll be like, wow, this game's easy as shit. Well, he'll get like a 60 first try, warlock.
Yep.
After you spend that much time on a warrior, dude, you rest. But F's in chat for Orym. Let's get an F, everyone, if you can.
Yeah, I mean, that was very well fought.
And Drinky, I'm going to watch that video after the thing, because we're wasting Kigo's time here, too.
Hey, we're okay.
I don't think Kigo's ever had his time wasted in his life.
No, we're good.
So I titled this one, Kitty Karuti, What the Actual Fuck Just Happened? And this is just kind of a fun one to watch, Kigo. I think it's best for you to not pull this one up on your own and just watch it on the screen share.
I'm just watching, yeah.
And chat, we're just going to observe this together. This shit's fucking awesome. I don't know what happened, but maybe someone in chat can tell me what happened.
Got the warrior. Oh, no. What? Where's he going?
He's typing a guilt chat.
Question mark. falling
through the world.
Oh, there he goes.
So, and the funny part is the hardcore
Alderman,
app,
right?
Yeah, he went straight through Alderman, dude. So the funniest part is when he dies, it says, you know, what is it, Fofano Ofenha HC the Warrior has died at level 18 in Lachmadon to Aria. I don't even know what Aria is. Who is Aria?
I don't know.
But yeah, it's so cool. Chat, watch this. When they charge, they fall through the ground, and then they fall through Alderman. And wouldn't you think, Kigo, I mean, correct me if I'm wrong, if you fall through another game asset, wouldn't you land on the top of Alderman or in it and die?
Like, you would think, right?
You'd think that you wouldn't fall through that. But that, like, straight through Alderman. Whoop, right there.
Oh, yeah, whoop. Okay, so, I mean, this happens with charge. I have no idea. Like, I don't think you could recreate it if you wanted to. It's one of those things. It's so rare. But you hear about it, right? It'll with so many people playing Warrior. So I'll tell you this. I was with Def Camp and Meldron leveling my Warrior, my first character through Classic. And we're killing Scarlet. We're killing Herod right there. You know, the spiral staircase. And I charged the little guys coming in that in waves that you kill at the end.
Mm-hmm.
And I went to the bottom of the ground and just like landed like on a solid, you know, like looked like a sandbox, right? Under Scarlet Monastery. And I shared screen and everything for him. And, you know, it's one of those things. Luckily I didn't splat like him, but yeah, charge will do some weird things sometimes.
It's wild, dude. It's wild. Drinky, you're killing me, man. I can't break away from this just yet, but I'll make you a deal, dude. I'll watch it immediately after with you if you want. It's stand up. I have it pulled up. No, I can't add him to the call because it would fuck up the whole Discord thing.
Right.
It's the movie guy stand up comedy.
Mm-hmm.
Just give me, let us get through this, Drinky. I really appreciate all the support and all that. Trust your boy Wiki. We're gonna we'll get it, and I'll get a fresh beer for it too because I need one anyway. Actually, you know what, Kigo? I'm gonna get a fresh beer now.
Do it
while we watch this clip that's no longer available. Great. We need to talk about this, chat.
Oh yeah, Coors time.
You guys know what this means, right? You know who this was supposed to be, Kigo?
Who?
This was supposed to. I'm just going to go there. twitch.tv/CrixGaming.
Oh.
Crix is out here deleting clips, bro.
Uh-oh.
Crix, if you're in chat, what are you doing, dude?
Uh-huh. We got to get them.
You think you can just delete clips to escape the F's in Chat podcast? Can't hide from your boy. We go to your clips channel.
It probably is Twitch griefing, true.
Worst part is I have a fucking threat meter.
Wait, is Crix live right now? Is Crix
2 days ago.
Wait. This is it. I have it right here. Dude, chat, I'm so good at this. Hold on. How do I literally paused his stream at the perfect time. How do I...
Silver, do you know this area?
Kigo, so this is going to be scuffed as fuck, chat. We're going to take the cameras off because this is... I have to full screen this for you guys in order to see it. Super scuffed, but just trust me, okay? Trust me.
I know this area.
I want you to see what's going on, okay?
I'd rather have Escape Artists than fucking World of Forsaken.
And I'm going to get a beer while this goes on. We're just going to watch Crix, chat. We're just going to pretend we're Crix right for a minute.
Yep.
Because Warlocks can dispel fucking everything that World of Forsaken needs does.
Chat, now that he's gone.
Everything World of Forsaken does, a fucking Fellhunter can pop out. Except for a Succubus Charm, which you don't even see in Arena anyway. Never one time. No. Maybe once. I'm over-exaggerating. Out of hundreds and hundreds of Arena game matches, maybe once, I was like, fuck, I wish I had What If. Because that shit is almost always off cooldown. It's on cooldown, yeah, but it's a 6-second cooldown. It's broken.
Okay, we're back.
You don't need to get that out of fear. Instead, take Escape Artist, which gets you out of a lot of
shit.
Let's go a little bit forward.
Fuck gnomes.
He pulled a thing, dude.
Gnomes are fucking stupid.
talking shit on gnomes.
The 27 elite, we gotta go. Okay, the 27
okay, okay, that's where it is, right there.
The hunter can pop out, except for Tangle is the most.
Okay, right here.
Fuck gnomes.
He's talking shit on gnomes.
Gnomes are fucking stupid.
Turn it down. Turn it down to save people's
fucking face. They're the ugliest class in all of World of Warcraft. I'd rather be a goblin on retail than a gnome. They sound
you
like shit.
If you don't want to die.
Like shit. Their hairstyles are shit. Their skin color is shit. Everything about them is.
Yo, this area is brutal. I lost Greta two here. Silver okay. lost her druid here.
That's why nobody plays a fucking gnome.
Oh, entering combat.
What is this? That's a 27 elite. We gotta go. Oh, it's not elite. Wait.
Oh man.
He's not even fucking my pet up that bad. Oh, we are pumping you down right now, bro. Oh shit.
Oh,
Frost
no.
Nova! Underwater!
Oh no.
Pet taunt, please god fucking damn it, growl.
Oh.
Pet taunt!
Oh no.
Fucking taunt!
Resist, dodge, miss, parry. Level 27, he's 22. Oh. Does that count? His head is touching the mic. Does that count?
That counts. Where's my display cap?
I'm so dead IRL pumping. I'm pumping!
Okay.
You know, I don't know if we have his last death clip. But it was almost a mirror of that on his hunter. Do you remember that?
It was literally the same. God yeah. damn it, Crix. Okay, chat, we're not going to do that. Okay, we're not going to show the clip because Crix likes to do this thing where he listens to like whatever music he wants to. Right? And I'm sure that's why the clips got deleted. 100% why the clips got deleted. So here's the deal, chat. Crix has this scroll wheel. When he dies right now, that he spins every time he dies. And he had to shave the top of his head to look like Aang from Avatar because of that death. So if you guys haven't seen the Crix Avatar death,
the Avatar haircut,
let me show you a screenshot of what that actually looks like. Because I had a clip of him actually shaving his head. Can you see that, chat?
Oh my gosh.
Can you see that? You see that Aang the Avatar haircut? Looking real nice, huh, Crix?
That looks good.
Yeah,
that does look good, though.
Let's just zoom right in. Oh, yeah, there you go, Crix. Looking great. And the funniest part about it, chat, is that he's not allowed to cut his hair until, or his facial hair, until he hits 60 on a hardcore character.
Until he hits 60.
Thank you, Taxic, for providing the photo. Taxic put that in the Among Us Discord that we're all in. And I was dying. F for haircut. That's what we need, yep. F's for the haircut.
F for haircut.
Major F's for the haircut. If you don't already, you guys should all go follow Crix and travel along with his hobo hardcore. All right. Moving on. We only have a few more here. Kigo.
Okay.
So this here is Ferguson 25 with a new sweatshirt.
Again?
Dude, he has a brand new sweatshirt for every occasion. Every occasion. Yeah. This time, instead of a bunch of toast, he's an Autobot.
Okay, okay.
And he's on another rogue. And it looks to be in the same area. He's in Silverpine again.
Oh, no.
But look at the range on this spider hit. Tell me this auto attack doesn't make any sense to you. And those spiders bubble, right? They always absorb all the damage.
All the evasion.
Do you see the range on that hit? Let's go back.
What the heck was that?
Look how far away from that spider he is. Is that a cast? It looked like a shadow spell damage hit him.
You know, I think I saw Tommy go over this clip this morning, and I think he said it has like a fireball cast that nobody knows about.
Oh, see, yeah. Okay,
so
Nom Nom.
I think he did a cast.
Nom Nom's in chat, guys. He says they have a fire blast ability that hits for 150. Taxi says he's jumped. And they heal. Wait, we have Nom Nom Rob and Nom Nom HC in the same chat.
We have, it's too powerful here.
Nom Nom, when are you going to get on the podcast? Let's talk.
True. That Nom was, Nom and Nom Nom.
Yeah. Let's
talk. You get the Nom Nom cast?
Let's talk about that. Yo, if Nom Nom Rob dies 3 more weeks in a row, I'm just gonna put a picture of him underneath us on the podcast. He'll be a permanent member.
Oh yeah, just put him down there.
No,
yeah.
Nom Nom, not on your warrior. I don't mean death. I mean like actually hosting the podcast with us. Well, let's talk.
Nom Nom Crow.
Nom Nom Crow. Everything. I know everything. Yeah, Drinky knows. Drinky knows all. But you know what, dude? Ego.
Yeah.
All of Ferguson's appearances, whether or not they are intentional or not to be here, he comes back every time with a new character.
Yeah.
With a new hoodie sweatshirt. With a renewed attitude. He's a killer. We appreciate Ferguson 25. He's learning from his mistakes.
From yesterday.
Pretty good. Pretty good. Yeah, chat, if you aren't posting highlights or death clips in the Discord, you need to, because everybody loves watching these things. Hell yeah, Nom Nom might be down, dude. Let's talk.
Yeah.
Yo, remember when I said we were coming back to new TV?
Okay.
Look, dude, he's back. So we had his first death on his hunter. Now we got his second death on his hunter. And he was live earlier, bro. He was chilling.
No. Female not elf hunter.
I love to see the renewed effort, though. You know, you come back on a hunter, you get your owl.
He's what, at least mid-20s here.
Now, this is exactly what happened to Crix on his hunter. In Duskwood.
Yeah.
Why are these both still attacking me? Why are they both still attacking you? Everyone, all the hunters complain their pet when they die.
You gotta panic, man, like.
I did. He keeps dodging my shit. Stop missing.
And see, I don't think he's level 30, so he doesn't have feign death. Oh, the hands.
The pose.
I got nothing.
I got nothing. So he looks at you. I got nothing.
I did.
Wait a minute. Is that?
Stop missing.
I think that's his. I think that's his significant life partner. In the background, use a potion, and he's like, I did. And then, oh my god, no!
Dodging my shit. Stop missing.
You hear that, guys? I don't think new TV is available on the market. I hate to break it to you, Drinky. I don't think he's single. Dang.
Man. Yeah, dang.
Yeah, much love to new TV, though. I'm glad he's back, like, playing nonstop.
Yeah.
You love to see people come back when they die. I'm waiting.
We got a mage.
Oh, there it is, dude. There was your brother. I heard him.
Oh,
I knew
no,
it was going to happen.
Yeah. He's here now.
I adamantly look forward to whenever you're live. I go in there and I look forward to your brother raging in the background.
You know, it's funny because the people haven't been around and have heard him in the background. Like, he streams too, so he has like his own emote. It's the Batty Flex here. I'll throw it to the. It's really funny. So you see that emote in the chat.
Yeah, he's buff as fuck too, right?
We were doing the dueling tournament with Jamin. I was one of the casters, and you know, we were doing that, and like the last little bit of it, he came by and you could hear him at one point. And then out of nowhere, I see that emote in chat, and I didn't even know my friends were watching it, the like tournament, but then started putting that emote in chat. It was the funniest thing. It's random, but
you know what's super funny is, you know, Misty Kiwi, right?
Yeah.
She's always in your chat.
Right.
Well, I didn't know that she was a roleplay potamus. I say she, I don't know. I didn't know that they were really polypotamous followers, subscribers.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
So I had never met Really Polypotamus. This is, I'm sorry, chat, we're going on a tangent, but I met Really Polypotamus at TwitchCon 2018, and I walked up to him because he was giving out business cards saying, hey, I'm Really Polypotamus. And I was like, dude, I'm a potamus too. And then we became friends. Turns out we live one city across from each other, and we both have mutual friends that we just had never met each other. Turns out Really Polypotamus is the ultimate homie. So then I run a lot of ads just like Really Polypotamus does on my stream. And the other day during the tournament, I ran an ad because I had to pee, and Misty jumped in chat and said, running your own ads, such a potamus thing to do. And it did not even register with me until later that she was literally talking about Really Polypotamus, because he does all these crazy ads too. It's fucking small world. Anyway,
yeah.
Shouts to Misty. If you're watching this at a later date, shouts to Misty. We know who this is, right? This is Big Kitty. Big Kitty's the Hall of Fame member, dude. He's a legend.
Got 60 on a rogue.
Got 60 on a rogue.
I haven't seen this clip.
So he posted this clip and he said straight up, this is what he said, Kigo. He said, the curse is real. I hit level 60. And this is my fourth death under level 20.
Yep.
Yep. Fact.
Yep. It happens.
You know what it is? You underestimate the challenge because you've done it. And then you realize, wait a minute, this challenge is really hard. And then you die to fatigue swimming at level 46.
Yeah. Well, look at me. Like, you know, I leveled my hunter to 60, did a rogue, got to 30s, but then died 5 times on a mage, you know?
Yep.
So there we go. Yep.
All right. So we're going to watch Big Kitty on his mage. These Murlocs are, you spend so much time here on these Murlocs because you need the spotted sunfish and you need the Murloc scales. And if you don't get them both at the same time, one of them is a quest you get later. One of them is a quest you get earlier. So the pro play is to like kill them until you get enough fish, even though you're done with the first quest. Otherwise you have to go back.
Right. You're going to be here for a good little bit.
But these Murlocs are also hyper spawns.
Mm-hmm.
Can you hear the dog chat in the background? Huxley's going crazy.
And the thing about mages at this level is their mana cost is ridiculous. And
oh, yeah.
He doesn't even have blink yet.
Mm-hmm. It's this quest, like, and he's doing the right thing, right?
Yeah.
He made the right play. Oh no, not the whelp.
Oh, the whelp.
Okay, good. Not the whelp. Oh, that Murloc was quick.
Oh, the charge.
Go to the charge again.
Go
to bear. So, okay, as a mage, as a Greta main, right?
Yeah.
Do you sheep? Do you risk sheeping before you leave, or do you just run?
Because
he sheeped
right there,
that one.
Oh,
that
Nova broke the sheep, though.
Do you re-sheep?
Right there, you sheep right there.
Okay, so you re-sheep, right. Then you run?
Yeah.
Okay.
You know that he's in a Nova, you re-sheep. Even if you have to stand there, you know, you re-sheep. Good thing.
That says he was Oom.
Okay, I'll say this too, and hopefully Big Kitty, it helps you. My goal for leveling, you know, as a mage right here, because I've done it a little bit now, my goal for Red Ridge is not coming here till level 20, not 19, level 20. You want to, because level 20 you get Flame Ward to deal with the whelps, and you have Blink, which this, you know, this is deadly here. So even if you'd pulled that whelp, you know, and you have Dampen Magic to deal with them. But yeah, level 20 is a good little note. But yeah, that Nova. One good thing to think about, and I'm just, you know, I'm not trying to, you know, he did all he could right there. If he wasn't Oom, he had saved it. Don't use Nova kind of offensively, because, you know, 10 levels later, you're going to be using rank 1 Nova 2 as well, or rank 1 Nova. You know, use that as a slow, not, because if you had just done another Frostbolt, you wouldn't have broke up the sheep.
I have to.
Kind of thing.
I want to acknowledge something, Kigo. Before we end this stream, there's two things I really want to acknowledge.
Okay.
If nobody in chat is following Cilantro Zoot.
Yo, he's there.
Bro. I'm typing this out. If you're not there following Cilantro Zoot, my man's, this was on the event board. They two man, so he's a duo player. They duoed all of Scarlet Monastery as a paladin and a priest. Okay. Batshit crazy, right? The fact that they lived through it. I watched this whole run, you know, there were so many cool parts of these runs that you guys miss. I clipped the last boss as proof to you that they two-manned RFD, and I'm sure they're not done yet. Okay, right. they it's on the event board. They post when they're gonna do it, and they two-man the dungeons, and it's literally mind-boggling. Like the fact that I was watching, because he's healing and DPSing, right? And the paladin's right. Tanking, so it's tank and healer. That's the only way that you could probably ever do it. The fact that he waits for his tank to get to like 50% because he's cooking a big greater heal, right? It's so scary. And on that boss where all of the skeletons are there and you pull them all, homie almost died.
No.
So, yeah, let's watch this clip here. Cilantro Zoot, my man. And he's just casually like mind blasting and holy firing, which is boggling to me, right? Because that's major threat, right? Mind blast?
Right.
Huge.
Right.
So then he
doesn't have
to
salvation
long.
Either.
Oh, that's actually true. I guess Kings is better, right? If you're not going to pull
Kings would be better. Yeah, I'm just saying, threat wise. It's kind of cool he didn't pull with that.
The spell. I'm
so look at how
out.
Low Fitzy gets before he even starts to cast the heal. It's like, six dude, that's come. Fitzy must trust everybody. The shit out of you. Oh, is that Fitz
drop
right there?
You could definitely see though he's hooks definitely beefy, right? Like the pally's not taking a lot of damage.
Yeah. And Fitzy's got shadow oil on his weapon from what it looks that's like. Man, I think at one point he had frost oil on his weapon.
Good fucking night, sir.
Let's go.
Good fucking night, sir.
The greater heal. See, that's spooky, but they've already done it.
And they talked about it before the pull. He said, fuck the ads. We're going to DPS the boss down. I'm going to drop a target dummy on the second wave of ads. Like, dude. Yo, Harkening, thanks for being here, man. I really appreciate it. Yeah, well done, guys. Whatever the opposite of
clean.
An F is, let's do brewskis or whatever hype emotes you guys have. Let's hype up Cilantro Zoot. And if you don't follow Cilantro Zoot, do it.
That was clean.
They stream everything they do, right? But sometimes it's like there's no camera and the audio's off, right? But if you go into the chat and you say, hey, Cilantro, turn your camera on and fucking talk to me, he will. He actually will do it right then and there. And then you just, boom, right there. Sometimes it just takes a little coaxing. You know what I mean? They're doing three-man Olda next. I hope you brought a hunter, bro. I hope you brought a hunter. I really do hope you have a hunter for that run.
The last boss,
you need
right?
a hunter for the last boss. Yeah. I don't want to say we did... three man most of Olda on accident once because Greta died. Okay, I'm gonna end the show with this and then we're gonna roll into some duos with Silver afterwards, but Kigo, I don't know if you're here every week in chat, but Gluk is a regular on the show in terms of dying.
Oh no.
And I want to respect the fact that Gluk this week, instead of dying, he pulled off the incredible. So I just kind of want to let this play and chat can just hang out and I'll be back in 2 seconds. But just watch what he does here, dude. He's opening with a cannibalized. Gluk is like the warlock prodigy who's like getting better every attempt.
Oh my gosh, that's scary. What's he gonna fear? Jason Statham?
Fucking Gluk, dude.
I felt like that. I feel like it's insane that he did that. 20 HP, I'm dying here in cave. That's what he said. Oh, no. Oh, but that's waves.
Bro, Gluk.
Oh, playing with my emotions. I thought he was good. Oh, no. He's so intense, too. He's got the sacrifice. Oh, and he's just going for it.
Book it, Gluk. Get out of there, dude.
The panic.
Book it, Gluk.
Oh, no.
Now that's what I'm talking about, Gluk. That's what I'm talking about.
My man's a legend.
I made it. How? Oh my lord.
Oh. Bro, Gluk the fucking legend, chat. We've spent 3 weeks in a row roasting Gluk on dying as a warlock, and this is what he comes up with in return. Look how close he was to death, dude. Here when the Voidwalker sack came out, and this is what I'm always talking about. Look how good the bubble is. He's got 5 mobs hitting him. Look at him run through all these enemies.
I don't know how, like, he fears one. Bubbles off.
Health pot.
He didn't hesitate one bit.
Gluk made me so proud, dude. A teardrop of like happiness fell down my cheek when I saw this clip.
Oh, yeah.
I mean that's definitely like.
How?
I think that's highlight of the week.
Oh my lord!
Like that's without highlight. Even voting, that is the best highlight I've seen in a long time.
Oh, it's insane. Yeah, I've never. Yeah,
did 16 health, and those mobs hit for 38 to 50, and there was 5 of them on him. So you know, this is a comeback story, chat. Right? Like, we roast Gluk all the time on dying and the things that he could have done better, but the fact that he lives through this, like, dude. Here on F's and chat, we give as much praise as we do. Salt, right? We talk a lot of shit, but we give it back. You know, dude, he deserves all that there is in the world for that.
I don't even know what to say to this guy. I mean, he owned it, dude. Like, I honestly probably would have just stood there and been like, that's it. But no, he went. Like, he went and he made it out. I don't know.
Yeah.
That was great.
If you guys want to follow Gluk and celebrate that win with him, here's his links.
Yeah, that was awesome.
He's come a long way since the first time we had him on the show. I think the first time we had him on the show was like the first time he ever died. Fucking Drinky, bro. You can't trick me, Drinky. I know that's you. It's not Gluk. Yeah, I highly suggest everyone follows him and go give him some congratulations. Congratulations. That is the, in my opinion, the clip of the week.
That was great.
Yes, Cargos, Kevin Jordan is going to play hardcore.
Yep.
Is what he said. He was saying it to Silver. Speaking
yep.
of Silver.
Next month.
Speaking of Silver, I think we're going to roll the raid into Silver's stream because I'm going to be duoing with Silver and you guys can hear me talk mad shit. Sound fun?
I think he said he was going to let us chat. So if you guys wanted to influence this, you know, go give Kevin Jordan a follow. I think he said he was going to let us chat. pick what he plays and, you know, like stuff like that, like have an influence on what he plays.
Darken, what are you doing? Darken, why? Thank
you,
though,
dude. Let's get some hype in the chat for Darken.
Yeah,
love
mad
to see
respect
it
for Darken. Darken, you need to message me on Discord after this, too. I've got some things
our
I want to go over
healer.
With you. Yeah, Darken the god, dude. The legend himself that... the oh, it took you two tries to get to 60? Yeah, imagine not making it on your first try. Darken.
Yo, Fitz, Tommy.
Thanks for the follow. Tommy's here?
Yeah.
Yo, can
way
we
past
talk,
his bedtime, but Tommy's here.
Can we talk about the hidden diamond in the rough? The highlight that I couldn't put on the show this week is Tommy getting a Kang the Decapitator off of the... Dude.
Darken. Oh. Yeah, we do have that one clip from the tournament, if you want.
Oh,
to...
yeah, let's watch that real quick. We have one more clip, guys. Let me pull this up. We'll give the stream a nice, funny exit, and then I gotta go over some stuff with Drinky and you, Kigo. Where's the group chat we're in? I can't even find it. Can you link that to me again, Kigo? I may or
it's
may not
in,
have it. Oh, I think I've got it.
It's in ours. And here's
yeah, I got
like,
it.
Another
I got
quick
it.
One if you wanted.
All right, chat. Darken's out here, dude, supporting too strong, man. Chat, we have to watch this. Before you leave, chat, before you leave, we're going to, you know what? I think what we'll do here, Kigo, what we'll do is we'll start the raid. And then we'll watch this as the exit.
There we go.
All right. You guys ready, chat? We're going to watch this as the raid fills. Here we go. This was epic. Oh, this is during the tournament, right?
Yeah, this is one of the guys leveling.
There is no way in hell! There is no way! I was looking so good! I had everything prepared.
That noise that he makes, the
night. Oh, it's so good. It's so good. Oh, look at his chat. That's Jaman's chat laughing because Jaman watched it like on stream as well.
Oh yeah, dude.
Oh, that's hold on.
So he dies in the tournament, killing the rare spawn.
So good. I had everything prepared. I got game time on NA.
He had to buy game time on NA to do that, by the way.
Yeah.
By the way, from what I heard in my chat, he broke his keyboard with that.
Yeah, he broke his keyboard.
He straight up broke it. Oh, shit. What are we doing, Kigo? Everyone, before we go, congratulations to Tommy Salami, the winner of the first dueling.